1932, Phu Nha Pact came into existence, communal reward, which was given by British Prime Minister Ramsay MacDonald. And because of that, 1932 Phu Nha Pact, there were separate electorates were given. But thereafter, because of Mahatma Gandhi's hunger strike, a 1932 Phu Nha Pact was signed between Hindu Congress and Dalits, that is the Republican Party of Dr. Ambedkar. And some seats were reserved. How many seats? Around 146 seats all over the three provinces of India, which are Bombay, Madras, and Calcutta provinces. So these three provinces, there were 146 seats reserved for depressed classes, backward classes. This was the situation pre-independence. At the time of independence, constitution was written by and constitution was prepared by Dr. Babasaheb Ambedkar. And what is constitution? Constitution is a document which contains laws and rules describing and determining the relation between government and the people and the form of government. These are discussed in the constitution. And due to this constitution and the articles mentioned in the constitution, I will narrate certain important articles which have given birth to this reservation policy. They are Article 14, Article 14, 14. Article 14 says equality before law and equal protection of the law. What is meant by equality before law? That all are equal before law. All would be treated equal in the law. But what is the equal protection of law? Equal protection of law has a different meaning. It has a positive aspect. Equality before law is a negative aspect, but equal protection of law is having a positive aspect. And this positive aspect, because of this positive aspect only, we have reservation in many parts of our life. For example, in the local train, you know there is a separate compartment for ladies and small kids. This is because of Article 14. We have kept this different compartment for ladies. So likewise, government has given a different treatment for different people. For example, exemption from taxes to this trust and non-profit making institutions, they are exempted from taxes. So this is also because of Article 14. Then comes Article 15. Article 15 talks about the basic rights. Actually, because of Article 15, 4, first time there was an amendment in 1951, and reservation for SC/ST was made applicable. In that particular amendment, also Article 340 was included in the Constitution, and backward classes commission can be appointed under Article 340. And such commission under the heading of Dr. Kalelkar, Acharya Kalelkar, was first appointed in 1953, who gave their report after 2 years in 1955, giving some odd 2,700 caste as a OBC caste, other backward classes caste. But this particular report was kept in cold storage due to the approach of Nehru government, that time Congress government, after the independence, and who did not pay attention to Acharya Kalelkar's recommendations, because some of the recommendations were negative. They were negative in themselves. Thereafter, in 1978, again, under the Janata government, B.P. Mandal was called to head the commission, which will look after the OBC reservation. And this particular commission was called as Mandal Commission. This Mandal Commission gave report in 1980, December 1980. And this also, this was kept in abeyance there after till 1990, till Mr. V.P. Singh government came into being. And when Mr. V.P. Singh was Prime Minister, he declared under the Mandal government, Mandal Commission, a government order dated 13th August 1990, declaring that 27% reservation to OBCs. Mandal Commission has stated that there is a 52% population in India is belonging to OBC. And Mandal Commission has given a report that they have searched, they have surveyed 405 districts of the country, and they have listed 3,743 castes as OBC caste. And thereafter, this was done on the 11 points. The points were based on which a caste would be declared as OBC. But here, this was not limited to only Hindu caste. Even Muslim, Christian, Buddhist, these are all caste. They were also included or taken for OBC listing. And some OBC castes are from these particular religions also. So thereafter, this particular reservation, there was a very much hue and cry all over the country when Mr. V.P. Singh announced this in 1990. Thereafter, before implementing this, there was a case called Indra Sahani case. Indra Sahani case, which was given judgment of nine judges bench, has given judgment on 16th of November 1992. 16-11-1992, the historical judgment, which has given rise to three basic judgments. That is, one is that they have accepted the recommendation of Mandal Commission of 27% reservation to OBCs. That was the first thing out of this particular case, Supreme Court case. The second one was the total reservation will not exceed 50% of the total vacancies in a year. So this was also another aspect, major aspect of this particular judgment. And one more thing, this particular judgment has given is creamy layer. Actually, this creamy layer word has come from which particular case? And that particular case is from Kerala. In 1976 in Kerala, there was a Thompson case. And in that case, first, the creamy layer word was used by Judge Mr. Krishna Iyer. And this particular creamy layer word, now it has been used in Indra Sahani case. And they have stated that certain income level, after which a person crosses that particular income level, after that he will not enjoy the fruits of reservation to OBC. So that is called creamy layer. And in this creamy layer, some of the government officers, government servants, they are also included. It is a big list declared by this OM dated 13th August 1990. So what is the creamy layer income level now? It is, how much it is now? It is around 8 lakhs. And that was declared on the 13th September 2017. 13th September 2017, this OM has come. And with effect from 1st September 2017, this particular income limit was raised to 8 lakhs. Now, after that, there was discussion all over that this creamy layer income level should be increased. So that was all about this history of reservation. Now we shall come to the actual session of what is a roaster. What is a roaster? Now, we can say roaster is a list of record. Roaster is a list of records of new entrants in the organization, in any organization. Rather, I can say. And it says that the record shows that how many percentages of the vacancies are given to particular category. And that particular category of the person is noted against his name in the roster. And his, whether he is a meritorious candidate or whether he has come on reserve point, all that will be explained or shown in the roster. So these rosters, now we are going to discuss about the rosters. Now there are two types. Earlier, there were two types of rosters so far. One is vacancy-based rosters and second one, post-based rosters. So vacancy-based rosters, they have come into being in the organization since the nationalization, for example, banks, nationalization of banks and all other government institutions from 1947, the first OM was given on 21st September 1947. First OM was issued for reservation in direct recruitment. And in 1955, first OM was issued for reservation in promotion. So this particular OM regarding government organizations and in banks, this has come from after nationalization of banks. And from in the banks, this particular roster implementation has started in our Union Bank of India. What I have seen here while working in Union Bank of India, that from 1/1/1972, the roster system has started giving effect to reservation to SCST recruitment. Now that time, the recruitment of OBC was not there. OBC recruitment has started and the implementation to in the roster has been given from the date 8 September 1993. So before those who have joined before 8 September 1993, they will be treated as general candidates. They will not be OBC candidates or they will not be occupying OBC vacancies. But for all other benefits, for all other benefits in the institute, in the organization, in the company where they are working, they will be treated as OBC only. But prior to 8/9/93, only SCSTs are given reservation. And also in promotion, there is no reservation in promotion. This is also one of the outcome of Indra Sahani case, that there will be no reservation in promotion to OBCs. Only there is a provision for reservation in promotion for SC and STs. And these were also many times challenged. Many times these were also challenged in various Supreme Court at various times. And now also it is challenged. Recently, they have given one justice in 2018 in the case of Jarnail Singh that why this creamy layer concept should not be applied to SCSTs also. And this question is also hanging now. Later on, it may come that creamy layer aspect is applied to SCSTs also. But we shall again come back to our main topic, that is the roster, vacancy-based roster. Now, what is a vacancy-based roster? As name suggests, vacancy means what? The number of vacancy declared by an institution in for recruitment purpose in the beginning of the year. For example, in today, that is to 2020, suppose a bank declares a vacancy of 1,000 candidates in Union Bank of India in the clerical cadre all over the states. So, include all over the states, they will be distributed some vacancies in comprising totally 1,000 candidates in clerical cadre. But suppose if that is a 1,000 vacancy in the officer cadre, then what will happen? All India will be taken as a one organization, and there it will be 1,000 officers vacancy will be there for on all India basis. And all India basis, as per vacancy based roster, how many seats vacancies will be reserved in the 1,000 vacancies for various categories? They are as per the all India level reservation percentages. And what is this percentages at all India level? There is a 15% reservation for SCs, 7.5% for STs, and 27% reservation for OBCs in that 1,000 vacancies which are declared by Union Bank of India for the year, suppose 2020. Now, how many seats will be reserved for SCs? 150 seats will be there for SCs. Then how many seats will be there for STs? 75 seats will be there, definitely. And then how many seats were there for OBCs? 270 seats. These are as per the vacancy. We have directly calculated 27% on 1,000 and it has become 270. Is it okay? So this is called vacancy base. Means as per the vacancy, the vacancies will be reserved in the roster. But nowadays, you know, one more category is also added. And that category is economically weaker section. 10% reservation on that also. So now one more question had arise and raised by many organizations that by including this 10% by 103rd amendment in the constitution, the 10% are added and the reservation total has reached to 59.5% reservation, which is exceeding 50%, the cap level of 50% declared by the judgment of 16-11-1992. Now, this is also challenged by some organizations in the court of law. We are not aware whether what is the judgment, final judgment about this, but that may also come soon. And the question of criminal error also will be discussed. So now what is the vacancy-based position of all these four categories? 15%, 7.5%, 27%, and 10%. But these vacancy-based rosters are not existing now. Why? Because of R.K. Sabharwal case. R.K. Sabharwal case was actually, it was from Punjab state. And from that, again, it has come to Supreme Court. And Supreme Court has given their judgment on 10th February 1995 regarding this R.K. Sabharwal case. Actually, the prominent feature is post-based rosters. What was argued in this R.K. Sabharwal case? That rosters should be maintained not on the vacancy-based system, but it should be maintained on post-based, because reservation is applied to post and not the vacancies. Reservation is applied to individuals, so that post is important and not the vacancies. And one more thing is that they have limited this particular percentage of reservation of 50%. So in that case, we'll today discuss how the post-based rosters and how they are maintained, as well as in what way they are inferior to vacancy-based rosters and what was the advantage we were getting at vacancy-based rosters. I will explain you by one example how this post-based rosters is a negative aspect, is a negative roster rather than vacancy-based roster. How it is not, how vacancy-based roster was superlative or superior roster than post-based rosters. And what is the meaning of post-based rosters? We shall see by one document I will reproduce here that can you see?
No. I cannot see that.
One minute.
You have to share the screen.
Yeah. Okay, sir.
Yeah. Now you have to click the button.
Yeah. So now vacancy-based roster, I have written here, say, for example, sanction strength, it is 1,000. Actual position, that is actual person in the job are 800 present. This is about vacancy-based roster, sir.
Yeah.
So what is the, as per reservation policy, vacancy of 200 posts, they will be recruited in the organization. Say, for example, in 2016, these 200 posts were advertised by Union Bank of India and 200 vacancies or recruitment was done in the officer cadre. So what is the percentage on all India basis? Because officers are recruited on all India basis. So the percentages are 15%, 7.5% and 27% and 50, general remaining 50.5%. And total will be 100%. That out of 200 vacancies, as per reservation policy and vacancy-based roster, how many points will go to, or how many vacancies will go to SC? 30. To ST, 15. To OBC, 54. And to general, 101. So total will be 200 in that way. So this is what vacancy, as per vacancy-based roster, directly as per the vacancy, you are, the share of entitlement is distributed. 30, 15, 54, 101 and 200. Is it okay that vacancy?
As
per vacancies, we have distributed the number of candidates or recruitment is done. And 54 vacancies are given to OBC as per 27% their share in the entitlement of 200 candidates. 200 posts. Okay. So this is what vacancy-based roster, and whenever the vacancies were used to be declared, suppose next time in 2017, suppose there are again one more 200 vacancies. So again, 200 vacancies will be distributed as per these percentages only. So again, one more share of 30, 15, 54, 101 and 200. So vacancy-based roster means every time when there is a vacancy declared by the institute, the recruitment will be done as per their sharing entitlement. So that is a vacancy-based roster. So every year there is a vacancy and suppose there is a recruitment, they will be shared in this manner. So now the strength of the sanction strength has become 1,000 in 2016 end. After that 2017 also there is one more 200 supposing that, then there will be again 1,200 total share, total organization strength, and there will be share of OBC will be 270 plus 54, that is 324 in 1,200. Okay. So like that, again, suppose 200 shares, 200 vacancies are recruited in 2018. Then again, in that also 54 vacancies will be given to OBCs. So their share will become 374 vacancies out of 1,400. Isn't it? So, so that is a arithmetic, just an arithmetic to distribute the share of the particular category, SC, ST, OBC, general. I'm just talking about SC, ST, OBC, general, excluding EWS, because that time EWS is not there. This EWS has come, economically weaker section has come only after 1st February 2019. So, I will not discuss that now. Only we'll talk about vacancy-based roster before for only three categories, that is SC, ST, OBC. So this is the way of recording vacancy-based roster. Only the recruitments, only the vacancy is taken as a prime concern. But due to R.K. Sabharwal case in 1995, which was the OM was issued on 2nd July 1997, and government has asked our banks and all the government institutions to take the effect of this post-based roster and to effect the post-based roster from 2nd July 1997. And this post-based roster is regarding the post, not vacancies. So now I have written here that from the above example, we will take this same example of 200 employees. That was a recruitment in 2016. But in 2017, from the above example, we presume that 200 employees resigned from the jobs. They have been resigned from the jobs. At the end of 2017, we knew that the 200 employees are vestiges or they have resigned from the Union Bank of India jobs. Out of them, 20 are from SC, ST 5, OBC 30, General 145. So total 200. Total 200 employees resigned from the or retired from the or existed from the organization. Now, these particular 200 vacancies have been shortfall. They are now shortfall for the total sanctioned strength of 1,000 employees in Union Bank of India. For example, now what to do? Again, we'll have to recruit 200 employees in next year, that is 2018, so that we can make up this sanction strength 1,000. So the roster size is same. Roster size is 1,000 employees. So roster size is same. But now the problem is that now as we have to apply post-based roster, as per the 2nd July 1997 order of Government of India. We have to recruit the people, 200 people, but the percentage of people as per vacancy-based roster will be 30, 15, 54, and 101. That is as per vacancy-based roster. But because of post-based roster, we'll not be recruiting that much. So how much we will be recruiting? As per post-based roster, we will be recruiting only 20 of SC. Instead of 30, we will be giving only recruiting 20 people, 20 persons from the SC category, 5 persons from the ST category, not 15, only 5. And instead of OBC 54 candidates, we will be recruiting only 30. So, and the remaining will be from general 145. So total will be making 200. Is that clear now that whatever there was a gap of those people who have resigned from the job out of that 1000 in 2017, those many people only we have taken back or recruited, that is a post-based roster. Now here the principle or policy of vacancy-based roster is removed. It is undone. It is not done. Because if they have, if would have done vacancy based roster policy, we would have recruited 10 more of SC, 10 more of ST, and 24 more of OBCs. But this could not be done because of post based roster orders, as per RK Sabharwal case. So what is lacking here? Here, the recruitment of the special this reserved category has become less, and we have recruited general people more because of those many people we have, those who have gone out of the institution, we have recruited them only. That is called post-based roster. Means whatever the we have done is here. It is we have replaced the persons who have resigned or we have got out of the institution. This is what post-based roster. Now, this particular post-based rosters we are maintaining since 2nd July 1997. So there is, I think you'll all note that there is a disadvantage in this post-based roster due to post-based roster policy. If we would have done vacancy-based roster as per vacancy-based policy, reservation policy, we would have got more people in the reserved category people in the bank or in the organization. So that was the main idea behind our main judgment of the RK Sabharwal case. So here, there would be less recruitment in the reserved category. So I think this is clear to all of you.
Okay.
So now here again, we will talk about, supposing that there are some more aspects of rosters. So that I will discuss. And that is, these rosters are called sometimes expanded. What is the meaning of expansion of rosters? Now, expansion of rosters means what? Suppose this sanction strength is 1,000 of Union Bank of India, say, of officers. Now, they have started opening new branches, and new branches will require new staff, new recruitment of officers. And they have increased this number of officers to be recruited by, say, 400 new officers will be recruited. Thereby, the total strength taking it to 1,400. So that is called expansion of roster. So roster points are expanded up to 1,400. And this particular roster, there can be a contraction of roster also. What is a contraction of roster? Suppose our bank, this particular bank is amalgamated in some other institution or bank. And thereafter, they wanted to reduce the number of employees. They have given VRS and reduce the number of employees to 800 people only, officers. So 200 people have been 200 people have been reduced from the total strength. So that is called contraction of the roster. So roster has been contracted. It has been reduced. So these are the two aspects. One is expansion and one is contraction or reduction. Now, how many types of rosters are there? There are three types of rosters, because mainly three types of roster. One is belonging to officers category in banks. In other institutions, there will be four types of rosters: class 1, class 2, class 3, class 4 categories. But in banks, there are only three types of roster. One is maintained for clerks, one is maintained for officers, one is maintained for clerks, and one is maintained for sub-staff or award staff. But in banks, our staff, there is two categories. One is for sub-staff, purely sub-staff, armed guard, etc. and one is for sweepers. So there are two sub rosters in the sub staff category, and in clerical category there is one roster, and officers category one roster. So, but these rosters are also maintained. These officers category rosters are also maintained grade wise or cadre wise. Grade wise. Grade wise means scale 1, scale 2, scale 3, scale 4, scale 5, scale 6, scale 7. Up to scale 7, there are rosters are maintained. But direct recruitment of officers are made up to scale 6 only. Up to scale 6, we are maintaining direct recruitment rosters, because there are direct recruitment rosters are differently maintained for each grade. And the rosters on promotion, the rosters on promotion are also maintained separately. Now, as I have discussed earlier, that OBCs are not given reservation in promotion. So there is a reservation in promotion roster only for SC and ST. So roster for promotion and roster for direct recruitment, these are the broad category of rosters. Out of this, roster for officers, roster for clerical cadre, roster for sub-staff cadre, these are three types of different types of rosters. Here also, again, there are points in the rosters. That is, 200-point rosters are different, 100-point rosters are different for different category. And again, there were earlier 40-point rosters, which are not existing now. Now all are 100-point rosters or 200-point rosters, or the most controversial, that is 13-point roster, or they were also called as L-shaped rosters. Now, these L-shaped rosters and all that we'll see afterwards. But before that, this type of 200-point rosters and 100-point rosters we'll discuss. Now, why 100-point rosters and why there is a need for 200-point rosters? We will see the examples later on, but we shall discuss this first. Why 100-point rosters? For whom? The 100-point rosters are maintained for regional level or state level recruitment of clerical category. Now, clerical category, they are recruited as per the state reservation, as per the percentage of state reservation. And these particular percentages of state reservation, they are also as per the government guidelines. I will show you that government guideline order under which the percentages are fixed, under which the points are fixed in the roster to which point of which category person will apply or will sit on which point number in the roster. For SC, ST and OBC, there are different points in the roster. Now, first of all, we shall discuss about 100-point roster and 200-point roster, for whom they are designed, for whom they are prepared. 100-point rosters are prepared, are made and maintained for clerical people, those who are recruited on regional basis or state level basis. And this is done as per their percentage in that particular state. And 200-point rosters are maintained and prepared for officers cadre. And this particular 200-point roster is also maintained in Delhi for clerical cadre. Only in Delhi, 200-point rosters are maintained for officer cadre, clerical cadre as well as sub-staff cadre. And why this is so? Why not in all other states we are maintaining 200-point rosters and we are maintaining only 100-point rosters? What is the reason behind this? The reason behind this is the fraction of reservation. The ST is enjoying 7.5% reservation in Delhi. In Delhi, ST reservation is SCST OBC reservations are 15%, 7.5%, and OBC 27%. So here, what will happen if I apply 100-point roster? ST people cannot be given justice, because 7.5 means we cannot cut into a person into a half and apply the reservation policy. So that is why, because of this 7.5 portion or percentages, we have to apply 200-point roster in Delhi for every category, that is officer cadre and clerical cadre as well as sub-staff cadre. So why 200-point roster? Because there will be 15 persons will be getting their reservation share in 200-point rosters, and we will be able to give proper points, allocating proper points for this particular roster. Now, all other states, apart from Delhi, they are all having the full percentage of reservation policy or reservation points. Likewise, say, for example, Rajasthan is having, say, 17%, or Maharashtra is having, say, 10% SC. Like that, it will be a round point. No fraction is involved in that. So this was the reason behind 200-point roster and 100-point roster, and as well as now regarding 13-point roster. Now, 13-point roster is maintained only for the posts which are 14 or less, where there are post sanction strength is less than 14. Less than 14, there will be L-shaped roster or 13-point roster will be maintained. But because of recent Supreme Court directions, this was not applied in the recent recruitments or admissions in the educational institute also. Because 13-point roster will not give any effect to ST category reservation. If there would have been a ST category person should be included in the recruitment, we have to give at least or maintain at least 14-point roster. And because in some institutions, there are vacancies of professors or vacancies of some special people, they are very less. Special posts, they are very less. So we have to recruit only, say, 3 or 4 posts in some years. Because in the beginning, suppose a person is recruited, he will not, till retirement, he will not go out. So there will not be a vacancy in that particular institute for in that particular post. So only by replacement, we can go to another point or next point in the roster. So we cannot give justice to all the category in a small roster or 14 point or 13 point roster on the L-shaped roster. That we'll take an example and also we'll see later on. But before that, now we shall talk about the normal roster of 100 point roster. Now we shall see some 100-point roster here. Now, I think you will be able to see one reservation register or roster, IDBI Bank Limited. Mm. I have taken some other different bank.
Because, Maharashtra.
This is from Maharashtra, regional recruitment, recruitment of regional recruitment from Maharashtra. Mm. And the post is pune or sub-staff post, sweeper like that. So how many number of posts are there? 55. Now, one more question is there in my mind. You may ask me that why reservation register? Why there is no roster word is written here? Sorry. Because of recent guidelines, some I think 2 or 3-4 years back, guidelines have come that there will be two types of registers will be maintained. One is called reservation register, and reservation roster register. Now, reservation register is a register which is maintained for 100 point and 200 point rosters. And reservation roster register will be maintained only for 13 point rosters. So that is why there are only two formats given or guideline or determined, or these are the government guidelines, as per the government guidelines. This particular reservation register is also a roster. Whereas in our bank, I will show you our bank roster also later on, where there is a slight change. But the actual format is of the government is whatever I'm showing you now. That is a IDBI Bank Limited reservation register. This is the actual format, ideal format. Our bank has modified this format and made it very easy and simpler, as well as convenient and easy to understand. But here in IDBI, this particular format of reservation register, which is not wrong, which is also correct as per the government guidelines, but certain things are lacking here. We cannot understand certain things. Now, for example, I will tell you, there are how many columns are here? Nearly seven columns are there. Seven columns are there in this reservation register. First is serial number, second is name, third is date of appointment, fourth is whether belongs to SCST OBC category or general, filled as UR or as reserved for SCST OBC, then second last is signature of appointing authority or other authorized person officer, and the last one is remarks. So this seven column roster register is called reservation register. And here only the problem is that the number which will be going to which category, that particular number, that is called a column called ideal roster column, which is not there in this register, which will you will see in our bank register. Here you will not be able to know how many posts are reserved for that particular category from this reservation register. But only see the last paragraph here. Here the summary is shown. Calculation of excess backlog for class 4 group 1 as on this date, particular date, as on 31st 12 2013. Now these rosters are maintained for calendar year only, not as a financial year. That is not from April to March, but rosters are maintained from 1st January to the 31st December of the year, calendar year. So whatever these recruitments are taking place between 1st January to 31st December, and whatever the vestiges or resign, retirement, and all those things exist are taking place between the calendar year will be recognized here and will be given implemented here in the roster while preparing the roster. Now, here you can see number of posts reserved as on 31-12-2013. That is for the year. 5, 4, and OBCs, they are making it instead of 14, it is 12. Now, this correction, particular correction in the 14 as 12 is made by me. IDBI, they are not knowing this particular mistake on their part. Actually, there is a mistake on that part, their part. I will explain you how it is and why it is. Now, persons in position is 18, 13 and 2. So, SC, there is a, how many persons are more? 13 persons are more than SC we have recruited. We have means IDBI recruited. Then ST, how many persons more recruited? 9. So total 22 persons are excess recruited in SC and ST category. But whereas in OBC category, they have shown as 12 persons less recruited. 12 is shown in bracket. That is a shortfall. It is called shortfall. So 12 is shortfall as per IDBI. But as per my calculation, the shortfall is only 10, not 12. Because the entitlement of OBC for that particular 2013 year, calendar year, is 12, not 14. And why it is so? I will explain you that also, why it is so. Now, we can see just the first page of this reservation register. In the first page, see, you can see the date of appointment. Date of appointment, you can see up to the person number 7. Number 8, up to 8. The person, Mr. 8, number 8 is M.G. Solanki. And he was appointed on 16th March 1993. Before 8-9-1993. What is 8-9-1993? That is the effective date of reservation policy to be implemented for OBCs. So only after 8-9-93, reservation policy effect or percentage effect will be given to OBC recruitment. So out of these 55 candidates, those who have been in the roster, out of these 8 are not after 8-9-93. They are prior to 8-9-93. So that is why what we will do, we will reduce 8 candidates from these 55. So total candidates are how much? 55, here it is. So out of that, if you remove 8 candidates, there will be, say, 47 candidates in the total. So out of 47, we'll have to take the share of 27%. That is the percentage of reservation for OBC. How much it has come? If you calculate it on 47, 27% will be 12.69. Is it correct?
Why we are reducing the date?
Because, as I said, that these 8 people were recruited prior to 8-9-93, 8 September 1993. So, the total effect of reservation, you cannot give on total, that is on 55 candidates. Your entitlement in this particular reservation register of IDBI of 55 candidates is from 47 only. You cannot be given the effect of 55 candidates total. Whether I'm clear on this or shall I explain again?
It is not on the total.
Total strength. It will not be on the total strength. It will be on the strength of the people, those who have joined the organization after 8-9-93. So how many people have joined after the organization after 8-9-93? Only 47, isn't it? So only on 47, you will have to get your share of OBC, that is 27%. So that share will be 12.69 if you calculate. Is it okay? Is that clear? Is that clear?
Go ahead.
Yeah. So 12% will be their entitlement for in this particular reservation register of 55 candidates. So here, the summary in this page, last page, what we have calculated here, I have made this change. This change is made by me, 12, by circling 14. So 12 will be the, what is that? The number of posts reserved. This is the number of posts reserved of OBC. Out of this 55, only 12 will be reserved. And how many are recruited? Only 2 are recruited. So what is the remaining backlog or shortfall? The shortfall of backlog is 10. Here, we presume that this is the first year of recruitment. So this is particular 12, that is 10, sorry, now. OBC backlog is 10 or shortfall is 10 is also backlog. That means shortfall and backlog are same. Because there is a different meaning of shortfall and backlog. They are not same. And here, which category is having excess? SC and ST both are having excess recruitment, 13 and 9. Okay. So here in this particular IDBI roster, reservation register, We have seen that what is the entitlement of OBC? It's not 14, it's 12. Why it is so? Because of the people who have been recruited prior to 8/9/93 are not counted, are not taken into account for calculation of your share of, that is OBC share of entitlement in the organization.
Is there any provision like that?
Orders are implemented for OBC reservation orders are implemented only from 8/9/93.
How can we give the effect to the I think we can discuss this in the post lunch because I am having that post based roster order of 27/1997. It says only about the cadre strength in a cadre. It never said that the OBC reservation chart roster should be given effect only from 8/9/93. You have to take that strength like that. And it has never said in the 27/1997. So my observation is that as a, suppose in a cadre, clerical cadre in a particular organization, if there are 1,000 numbers in a cadre, then you have to give 270, irrespective whether they join prior to 8/9/93 or 93, it is immaterial. That is what my observation. We will discuss in the post-lunch session because the total thing, This chart, everything will be distracted now. So you explain this one and that part I will also discuss with you in the post lunch. Together with this, you have to just tell us about this All India recruitment otherwise than open competition.
That also we will discuss. So we will discuss this particular aspect in after post lunch. That is okay. So now coming back again to this particular reservation register, IDVR reservation register, I have shown you. Now one more register is there, that also I will show you. But regarding this particular summary, there are only two aspects you are shown in the roster. This I have picked up from their website. So we are showing only reservation roster register and the summary. This summary is also, they have not shown as per the guidelines of this government guideline. MOF summary is not there. Only a small summary, which is tabulated here in the last portion of this statement. Okay. But in our bank, Union Bank, we are having one more summary, a separate document, which is signed by all the GM and all liaison officer and all. So that particular statement is also there, that is called MOF summary or Ministry of Finance summary. Okay. So here, that is lacking here. One more thing, how many are there? What is the required ideal roster? How many people will be there recruited for each category is not clear, is not very easily can be pointed out. So that is the lacuna of this roster, actually, isn't it?
Yeah.
So now I will show you one more roster, that is.
You can tell about otherwise than open competition.
Okay. Otherwise than open competition, that is actually it is called as a campus register. Campus roster. One minute. This campus register, this is also maintained for those otherwise than open competition. If the bank is recruiting people from various institutions, a special category persons, officers, in that particular aspect, a separate roster is maintained, and that roster is having 120 points. Why 120 points? Again, not 200 point roster, because the percentages that is fixed for this particular campus recruitment, or what you can call otherwise than open competition, is 16.66% for SC, 7.5% for ST, and 25.84% for OBC. Now, if you take the total of all these three percentages, the total of all these three percentages will be 50%. If you take the total, it will be 50%. And as for that particular, because of these percentages, the roster has to be made for 120 points. Because to give effect to all the categories properly, we have to make it, that means every cycle of recruitment will be of 120 points, not 200 points. To give effect to all the categories properly, to give justice to all the categories. Now, 100 point roster is maintained for all other clerical cadre. Why? Because clerical cadre, they are as per the state percentages, and state percentages are not having any fractions. So that is why state level rosters, they are maintained 100 point rosters, as but campus rosters are maintained as per 120 points. Now, in out of 120 points, how many points there are of this OBC? How many points OBC will get? How many points this SCST will get? You can see that in 120 point rosters, if you apply that, 31 points will be received by OBC. Out of 120, 31 points will be by OBC. Then how many points will be given to SC and ST? SC will be taking 20 points. 9 points will be taken by ST. So 20 plus 9 plus 31, this total will be 60 points. Out of 120 point roster, this, out of this 120 point rosters, 50 points are reserved. So,
yeah, 50%.
Yeah, 50%.
Yeah. Well, the OBC is reduced to from 27 to 25.84.
Yeah.
Correct?
So this 120 point roster will have 31 points of OBC, 9 points of ST, and 20 points of SC. So these campus rosters are now, banned, because campus recruitment is banned. So there is no other, other than open competition, there is no recruitment on that ground. So nowadays only some old recruitments are there. For that, our bank is also having rosters up to scale 3. We have taken campus recruitment. Otherwise, now no other banks or institution, they are doing this open company campus recruitment. It is totally banned. Now, regarding this 200 point rosters and 200 point rosters, we shall see some rosters
examples.
Yeah. Just a minute. See, I think you, whether you can.
You have to expand it.
I will just expand it. Now, this is our bank's roster only, Union Bank of India. This is the Kerala, state of Kerala. I have taken as an example. Year 2018, This is post-based recruitment roster. Name of the post is sub-staff, housekeeper, compute. You can read from here, from the screen. And state of Kerala, method of recruitment is direct recruitment. And number of posts in the cadre is 170 total. This is for housekeeper. This is for housekeeper.
So the reservation percentage will vary.
Yeah, reservation percentage, because state of Kerala is having a percentage of reservation. See here, it is mentioned here.
SC you can point out that.
Yeah, SC 10%, SC 10%, ST 1%, and OBC 27%.
Yeah.
So here, these three different, and their grade is also written, how much basic they will be applying. That is also given. Yeah. Now, this particular roster will have how many columns? 7 columns. I have told you earlier also. See, this first column is called cycle number or point number. Now, before going to that, this is 100 point roster. This particular roster is 100 point roster. Why? Because it is a regional or local roster for sub-staff and clerical cadre. They are maintained 100 point rosters. And why it is so? Because of percentages. There is no fraction in this particular state percentages. All are full integers, 10, 1, and 27. That is the reason behind following 100 point roster. Okay. Now, this cycle number is there and roster point number is this. First column is given to cycle number. Cycle number means what? A recruitment cycle. So how many points will be there in one cycle? There will be 100 point in one cycle. 100 point roster will be there. Recruitment will be there, 100 points, and it will be treated as one cycle. So after 100 is over, again, 101 to 200, there will be the second cycle. That is called second cycle. But the number will be taken as 1, 2, 3, like that only, chronological order, 1, 2, 3, like that. So it will be 100, suppose now here, there will be a roster of 170. So 170 will be the total number of roster points. See here. So last will be 100, and here it is 164. One example roster I have taken, where in 2018, earlier it was 170, now it has become 164. This 170 was for year 2017. 2017 end, that is 31st 12 2017, this state of Kerala was having 170 people. But during the 2018, 6 people were reduced or vestiges. So these 6 people, see, I am showing you, this sheet is called vestiges. Statement of vestiges. Are you able to see this statement?
Yeah.
Here, how many people are mentioned? 6.
Yeah.
So that 170 minus this 6, so that is the number of this today, this what I am showing, 164 candidates in the roster. So these 164 candidates are for the roster of 2018 roster. These candidates are 164. Okay. Now vestiges are removed from that 170, and that is 164 it has come. Now, what about admissions, recruitment in the total year? There is no recruitment. See here, it is nil. See here, it is nil. Nil is here shown, it is. Okay. All are able to understand, no? This nil, it is written here. See, this is the statement of addition. That is the recruitment in the year 31st 12 2018. And it is nil. So there is no recruitment or no addition in the roster. What was the roster in the last year? Total roster points were 170. Total people in the present in the roster were 170. Okay. At the end of 31st 12 2017.
Okay.
Okay. During the year 2018, there is no recruitment or no addition. That is nil. Now during the year, vestiges are 6. So 6 people have been existed out. existed out from the roster. That is, see here, four people are on promotion, promoted as a clerk. These are the sub-staff category, housekeeper. Yeah, yeah. So out of them, four people have become promoted as a clerk. They have become clerk. Okay, that is the vestiges. Then one is retired in March and one was terminated. So these are the six people who have gone out of or existed out of the roster of 170 candidates in the last year. Now, what is the seniority list? This is called seniority list. This seniority list and the roster should be the same. And it is 164 candidates. See here, seniority list, last candidate. It is last is 164, correct? And what is the roster total? 164. So these candidates should be tallied. There should not be any difference. Not a single difference should be there. Single person difference should be there. So they are both same. Here also the person will be same. Because from date of joining, their seniority list is arranged. This is a seniority list, which is arranged as per their joining seniority in the bank. This is a joining date. See here, it is a joining date 1985. One lady had joined this first number one in the roster. And the last person who has joined in the roster is in the year 2018, 9th of May 2018. This is the 164 person. So total roster is of how many people? 164. Okay. Now out of this 164, as per the percentages, what is the percentages? 10, 1 and
27.
So from because this 10%, how many people will be of SC category will be recruited? Or their share of entitlement will be how much? On 164, 10% will be 16.
Yeah.
Is it okay?
Correct.
So what about 1%? 1% of ST? Only 1% will be recruited from the ST category. Now that point, that ST point is shown as here point number. Say
99.
Mm-hmm. Sorry, 1 minute. Here, I will show you the roster. From roster, it will be very clear. So roster, see here, 96. Sorry, 96 it is shown. 96 it is shown as ST. 97 is SC, 98 is OBC. 98 is OBC, it is here. So 90, see this particular point, how they have arisen, how from where they have come, that we will discuss. But just that we will discuss actual calculation also, I will show you how it is done. But before that, just I wanted to show you this example of a roster, 100 point roster. Now this roster is applicable to whom? Only regional recruitment.
Yeah.
Okay. And here, see the first up to 1992, that is up to three, serial number three, it is 1992, three candidates they have been appointed prior to 1993. So what has happened for OBC calculation of vacancies? 3 points we have reduced from 164. How many? 3 points we have reduced from 164. Total strength is 164, isn't it? So 3 points we have reduced from 164. So our 27% will come 43 candidates only out of total. But if you would have taken 164 candidates, the total share of entitlement of OBC would have been 44, one more. Because of these three candidates, they were recruited prior to and of that, prior to here, this is not OBC, this is your general category, OBC category, but generally on general category, he has been taken in the recruitment. So these three candidates, they were taken prior to 8/9/93. That is why we have reduced it from the total, as I explained earlier also. So why it is so and not, that we'll discuss after post-lunch session. That is true. So now here also, you will observe that in the MOF summary, in this summary, MOF, see, this is the MOF summary. Whereas IDBI Bank Reservation Register, we don't have such a summary, such a big summary, which is a elaborative summary, which is signed by the regional head and all those people on the all the authority. Here, the earlier, see, earlier was 170, now it is 164. So this is the first row will contain all the previous year's carry forward. And here now you can see here 43. Now this 43 is a share of entitlement post reserved as per the percentage of reservation. And that is under method of recruitment, direct recruitment. So 43 people were, means 43 people would have been recruited as per reservation policy, not 44. Because 44 is for total 164. Mm. Now this is calculated as on the 161, not 164. Mm. So that is the difference here. And actually, in fact, recruitment is more, 74. So near about 31 people are more recruited in OBC category in Kerala, in housekeeper category. SC also, there are nearly, say this 38 people are more, and ST also 3 are more. So in each category, there are excess recruitment in the housekeeper category in Kerala. So there is no question of here now shortfall, isn't it? There is no shortfall here. It is all excess, surplus. See, here it is mentioned surplus. So when these are covered or shown by negative sign, then it will be a shortfall. So that is why this MOF, Ministry of Finance, they require this summary, because everything is clear here. But one more thing is not clear here that I can tell you is backlog. Now, nowhere backlog word is written here. See, even in the IDBI register, reservation register, the backlog word is not written there. Backlog word is not there. Backlog is not shown in by any industry or any institution, any bank. That particular statement is given separately to the Ministry of Finance when they ask for backlog and all. But that is not shown here. So whatever we see, shortfall and excess, is not the true picture of backlog. You cannot construe black backlog from there. Now what I said regarding IDBI, that particular reservation register, presuming that that is the first year of recruitment, then the backlog would be 12. Out of 12, 10 backlog is there for OBC. But if it is not the first year, and if that is not the first recruitment, then backlog would be different. Backlog may be more or may be less than what it is shown as a shortfall. So backlog is a very different concept. And that also I will show you in the after the post-lunch session. I will show you that also. Because now also I think we are nearing to 1 o'clock. And and I want to show you some more statements also here in along with this roster summary. See, one more statement is also there here. I have shown you additions, wastages, and bank summary. Now, this bank summary is only prepared by our bank only. No other bank or institution, no other institution is preparing this summary. This particular summary will show you backlog. Now, this is the backlog, reservation summary backlog. Now, there is no backlog in state of Kerala in any category. It is zero. Now, this is carry forward from the beginning, from 1997 or whatever it is. So This is carried forward from long current reservation, and then you have to add the earlier reservation plus current reservation, then grand total, then reservation. See here, last number of reserved vacancies are carried forward for next year, next recruiting year. That is called backlog. So here there is no backlog. See here, total backlog. So here it is 000. So there is no backlog in this particular housekeeper category in state of Kerala. One more roster, I will show you of Mumbai, where there is a backlog in some category. That also I will show you. So now this is what a small roster I have shown. One small roster also we'll see for practical exercise after post-lunch. This one matter. No. One more roster I will show you. Oh, see this now. 1 minute. See, this is the seniority list of Chhattisgarh, our Union Bank Chhattisgarh state. There are how many? 39 candidates are there. Now, total candidates are 39 here. Here, vestiges are how many? 8. 8 vestiges are there. And how many are additions? This is the year of 2016 I'm talking about. Year 2016. Now, year 2016, how many candidates were recruited? 16. 16 candidates are there. See, this is the addition list. This is called list of addition. So for preparation of this roster, we require these two things. That is, statement of additions or addition list or recruitment list, and statement of vestiges, another. And first is a seniority list. That is the third document. Fourth is roster of previous year and summary of previous year, because from that summary we have to take this year's summary. So these are the five documents which we are required for preparation of roster. Now, this addition also, you can see here, there are some meritorious candidates, OBC, MT, 1, 2, 3, 4. So out of these 16 candidates, you can see that there are meritorious candidates, OBC, which are taken in UR category, which are not taken in the reserved category of OBC.
Yeah.
So these are additional, more than reserved category OBC candidates. Likewise, SC also 2 are there. And the only reserved category candidate is only 1 candidate from OBC, 5 candidates from ST, and 2 candidates from SC. So 8 candidates are taken on reserved category level, and say 6 candidates on meritorious grounds of SC and OBC, and 2 general candidates are there. So only general candidates out of this 16, only 2. Only 2 general candidates, otherwise all are belonging to reserved category. Because this OBC category, one OBC MT 1, 2, 3, 4, they are all on general category. General, you are. They are all you are, general category level. So this is the advantage here. We are taking it separately. Now, these are also shown in the category, in the roster separately. Roster there will be as a UR candidate, not as a, I will show that roster. No, roster is, no, okay. No roster actually, what?
Sir, welcome, sir. Tell me, sir. Nothing is happening.
Here, nice. Here, I have shown you the blank roster. I'll show you the other roster also. But here, this other roster, there will be complete this thing. I just wanted to take an example of roaster, how it is made. That is why I made it blank, but I will show you the actual roaster also. 1 minute.
Hello?
Hello. Just a moment. I'll show you another roaster. No. See, this is a Mumbai roaster. I will show you this roaster also. See, this is a summary, bank summary. This is the roster. This is the roster of how many? 153 candidates. This is Mumbai's roster. Mumbai housekeeper. These are how many? 153 candidates are there. Here, see, there are many candidates who are before 1993, there are nearly 12 candidates. So again, the same rule will be applied for determining the strength. So in MOF category, MOF summary, you will see that OBC is how many? 38. Out of 153, 38 is the entitlement. Actually, how many should be there? 153 into 27 divided by 100 will be 41 candidates. So, three candidates are less here. Here also the same thing. Same rule is applied, same policy is applied here also. Here also additions, if you see the additions, there is only one addition. But vestiges, there will be many vestiges, 16 vestiges are there. So, these all statements are necessary for preparation of a roster. Roster will not be... able to prepare a roster unless these all statements are there, available. Now, this is the requirement for all, for officer category, as well as for clerical category, as well as sub-staff category. Now, all these rosters are prepared at the end of the year. That the year is over, the preparation of roster will be taken. And within a month, the rosters are ready. And then after that, the rosters are inspected by the liaison officer. Now, every institution, bank, they are having this liaison officer. And this liaison officer is of the rank of general manager level. And under this general manager or liaison officer, one sale will be there. That sale will be called as SCST OBC welfare sale. And that particular sale in charge will inspect the rosters and present the rosters for signing before these liaison officers. And later on, there will be a report at the end of the year. A report will be sent to the, put up to the managing director of the institute or the highest authority of the institute or a bank or organization. And that in that report, they will point out any lacunas, any differences are there or any errors are there in the roster. So that was the idea about roster I have given here to a 100-point roster. Now there are some other rosters are also there where are 200-point rosters are also there, which is maintained for officers. Now that I have opened is a clerk roster. I will show you one clerk roster also. 1 minute. See, this is a roster for clerk for Delhi. They are having nearly 355 candidates total. 355. This is a roster for clerks. They are similar. Clerks and sub-staff roster, they are all similar. Only percentages are different here. But why it is here? See, 15%, 7.5%, and OBC 27%. This is for Delhi. The Delhi is the only exceptional roster where we have to maintain and calculate the share of entitlement as per that 200-point roster because of this fraction, 7.5. Okay.
Yeah.
So that is a roster for Delhi. Sorry. Yeah. Now, if you see the roster for Goa, for clerk, here also there is a 2%, 12% and 18%. So there is no fraction. So here you can maintain 100-point roster. So that is the only difference. Otherwise, there is no much difference in the rosters. Only I wanted to show you that officers roster. Actually, I will be showing you that after the post-lunch session. That I will make it clear. Now, what do we can do? We can stop here for lunch.
Yeah.
So that I can, after the post-lunch session, we'll discuss totally on different rosters also, as well as how roster on the screen itself, so that you will also, side by side, you will also do roster. Or it will be taking much time, I think.
Post-lunch, you discuss about 13-point roster.
It will not take much time.
Yeah, but yeah.
What I wanted to make it clear, how the roster is actually prepared.
Yeah.
Do you want that or do you...
How much time it will take?
No, it will take around half an hour.
Uh-huh.
One roster, half an hour it will take. I will take the small roster only so that you can...
Yeah, so that...
10 points, not 10 points.
So yeah. That...
small roster.
Yeah.
So it can finish within 15 minutes or like that.
Yeah. So only for understanding.
Basic understanding.
Yeah.
So that is very important. And then 13-point roster only it is a... Actually, we are not maintaining in our bank 13-point roster. All small vacancies are also in the 100-point roster or 200-point roster, not 13-point roster.
Okay.
So that is what...
just for academic interest, you can explain.
Yeah, academic only. And
some organizations, they may maintain.
Yeah.
At that time, we can discuss it.
Acha, Mr. Natarajan has to say something, I think. Mr. Natarajan wants to speak something. Hello, Natarajan.
Unmute.
Sir. Yeah.
Sir, can you hear me?
Yeah.
The campus interview, now it is stopped.
Yeah.
What about the backlog of campus interview? It will be added to direct recruitment?
Yes. That was done last when I was in the bank. It was decided like that only, that they will add that backlog in the this direct recruitment. And they have done also certain things. You can check up with our bank also.
So in the post-based roster,
yeah.
So this, whether the 27% will be maintained in particular calendar, it is not possible at all. 27% reservation.
Yeah.
Whether it will be maintained on a particular calendar year?
Yeah. Also, when recruitment is done, suppose in a particular calendar year, recruitment is done, say 600 candidates are recruited. So on that 27% reservation will be applied, definitely. What do you want to say about whether it will be less or more post-base, as because of post-base? So there is no question of post-base here. Suppose, I will tell you why, how it is. Suppose you have recruited more candidates earlier year, you have recruited more candidates, say 40 candidates more in your OBC category. And now you are recruiting 400 candidates as a new candidates, 400 vacancies. 400 vacancies are declared by Union Bank, correct? And 400 candidates are taken. So how much for 400 candidates? How many is the share of OBC? 108. 108 in out of 400. Isn't it correct? Out of 400 vacancies, 108. But bank will not recruit 108 OBC candidates. They will recruit less 40, that is 68 candidates they will be recruiting. So in that calendar year, as per the vacancies, you will find that less recruitment has been done in case of OBC. But why this is so? Because earlier year we have done excess recruitment. Now it is clear. So calendar year wise you cannot tally. But when you are taking the roster for inspection, there you will get that. There you will tally. There in that summary you will get the correct picture. That is why many a times Dr. Amrutanshu and Dr. Mr. Ravindra Ram, they used to ask about this particular question. So why this year there is a difference? And they used to inspect the rosters. But then there also they found that as per the rosters, if you see that, and as per the figures given in the meeting, they will not be tallying. The meeting figures will not tally with the roster figures because they are the figures given during for the recruitment during the year. The entire picture of preparation of roster will be done at the end of the year. And after that, whatever we'll prepare, that will show the correct effect of the reservation about OBC or about the reserve category. So you cannot take any particular year as a recruitment year. It means for vacancy, for your calculating your category vacancies, you will have to take the entire roster as a for reservation percentage or share of entitlement of OBC. See, this is a boss, Chhattisgarh, state is Chhattisgarh. This is the seniority list. They are having 33 candidates total on the seniority list.
Hey, Katakurad.
And this is for roster. It is also will be showing 33 candidates. This is of, I think, housekeeper compute. There are how many? Nearly 33 candidates. Total. Again, here, if we see this roster, it will have eight columns. Date of birth is also given here, but date of birth is not necessary actually. Up to remarks column, it is there. So first column is cycle number. Then next is the column number 2, which consists of two numbers, category and number. Category is what? That is general category or whatever category it is. General, SC, ST, OBC, like that. Now, first one is UR1. If you see the column 2 under B, subcolumn B, there are two subcolumns, B and C. Actually, it is UR1 means 1. That is UR1. That is general. UR means general, unreserved. Okay. So, first 3 are all are UR. This is given as per the guidelines given by the government, state government. For states, how many percentage will be there?
Yeah,
because
yeah.
Chhattisgarh is having SC for 12%, ST 32%, and OBC only 6%.
Oh.
Because here OBC population is less, so Chhattisgarh only 6%.
Okay.
So reservation is also only, entitlement is only, out of total vacancies, there will be only 6% will be entitlement. So out of 100, only 6 seats will be reserved for OBC. That is the criteria or idea behind the percentage. Now here OBC seats will be less out of 100. Now here only 33 seats. That means it will be around hardly 1 or 2 seats or 2 seats maximum. Isn't it?
Yeah,
so
yeah.
Here maximum will be tribals or ST. Then next will be SC. So here we can see on this second column, 21 serial number, OBC1 is there. Means on 21st point, first OBC has come. So naturally, next OPC will not come within 33. So within total strength of 33 candidates, roster candidates, only that 33 roster vacancies, only one OBC is entitlement. Okay.
Okay.
So, so this particular two, well, I think somebody has voice is coming.
I request kindly mute your audio, please.
So what I was telling you, that this particular column number 2 describes the ideal roster, means what the roster point should be by as per the government guidelines. This is what your entitlement of all the categories, SC, ST, OBC and general. Even general also, how many seats will be there for general? Total last 19 will be there. So out of 33, 19 seats are going for general as per government guidelines. OBC 1, that means 20, ST 10, that means 30 total, and then SC only 3. So total 33 are divided like this. SC 3, ST 10, then OBC 1, and general 19. So this is the breakup of all 33 candidates or 33 vacancies in that particular state, that is Chhattisgarh state. So these are the housekeepers, and this second column is denoting us or showing us the entitlement, share of entitlement of each category, which is not shown in other rosters, what we have seen in the morning session, IDBI as well as some other rosters also I will show you. In other rosters, other banks' rosters, this particular column is not there. Because of that column, we will come to know immediately how much is my share in that roster, immediately, isn't it?
Yeah.
But actually then column number 3 and 4, they are talking about the candidate's description. That is, what is their employee ID, what is their name, and what is their joining date. But then column number 5 and 6, they are again now describing us a different nature of the roster. That is, whether the person is SC, ST, OBC or general, means the person who is recruited. For example, first person, Kamal Kumar Yadav or Yadu. Kamal Kumar Yadu, now he is a general, you are. It is written unreserved because his category is general. So, next column, sixth column, it is written how this post is filled. This post is unreserved. Unreserved post means it will go to general category person is having this post. So it is general, it is written. So the two generals are there. First two columns are, first two entries are general. Thereafter, one Gond is there, Shyamlal Gond, third entry. And that is going to tribal, ST. So he is person belonging to ST category. So he has been filled in as ST, means in reserved category. He is not meritorious candidate. So he is in ST category. It is shown under ST1. So like that, ST1, 2, 3, like that. And the first OBC has come in the year 2008. See, OBC. First OBC is Omkar Sahu. He has come in OBC. So he is the first OBC person who has been given entry or recruited on reserved category of OBC, not on meritorious. Now, if you go on seeing downwards, entry number 16 and 17, OBC MT 1 and 2. Now, these are OBC candidates, but on meritorious. So they are shown as general, because they will be unreserved, they will occupy unreserved category post. So they are occupying general category post. Okay, they will not be shown as a reserved category.
Nice.
Likewise, there is SCMT, that is general, SC general, meritorious candidate. Thereafter, in this particular roster, nearly six candidates are OBC candidates are shown as meritorious or general. Okay, only another one candidate is there who is OBC too at the last, Rajiv Sekar. So he is two persons are recruited on reserved category in the reserved category of OBC instead of one. What is our requirement? Our requirement was one here on the left hand side against the serial number 21. This is our requirement. But whatever we have recruited is how many more? One more. That is two candidates we have required, recruited. We required one, but we recruited two. Plus, addition to that, six meritorious are also there. So in this case, particular case, there may not be any backlog. There is no no shortfall. There is no shortfall at all. But there may not be any backlog also. We'll see the backlog also, whether it is backlog is there or not, but may not be there. I'm not sure. I've not seen a so far summary. Because what happens, shortfall or excess, you can see from MOF summary, that is Ministry of Finance summary. That is the total summary at the end of a particular year. But recruitment is done during the year. And in that recruitment, suppose we require 10 candidates of OBC and we could not get 10. We could get only 8 candidates. That means what happens, 2 candidates we could not recruit of OBC category. Then that two OBC candidates requirement will be called as a backlog. That will be a backlog. But here we'll see the MOF summary and we'll find out whether there is a excess or shortfall. Now here it is, see the last column, 15 number column. It is one. At the end it is written one and it is not minus, it is plus. That means your requirement was one, OBC requirement. But how many you have recruited? Two. That means one more. So here it is excess, surplus. Because as per the position of roster, as at the end of the year 2016, so it is how much? 2017, it is how much? One more excess. SC also three more. SC also three more. So means total 7 candidates are excess taken by the Chhattisgarh in the reserved category. Now these 7 candidates are taken out of the your entitlement. What is total your entitlement? Now total your entitlement, just now we have discussed 19. How many? 19. Do you remember this roster 60, roster C?
Yeah.
Here in the last row, row, if you see, what is the requirement? You are 19. Isn't it?
Yeah.
So against you are 19, you have, we have, how many we have? We have only 12 UR candidates.
So seven.
Seven. So these 7 are coming from this 3, 3 and 1. So the last last 3 columns, they are showing us excess or shortfall. Last 3 columns of this MOF summary, 337, 331, this shows us excess or shortfall. Now here in this case, there is all excess. And where from it has come? From the UR.
Okay.
Now this 12 UR also, there are 4, how many this thing was there? Meritorious? 6. 6 OBC are meritorious. They are also included in that 12 UR. And 2 SCMT. That means 8 candidates out of 12. Out of these 12 candidates of general shown, 8 candidates are belonging to meritorious reserved category. That means only pure general category are only 4. Okay. Is that clear, sir?
Yeah.
So this is what I wanted to explain you, that roster here, this column is very important. This column immediately shows us what is required. And this particular column 5 and 6, they show us what is the actual position, what is the fact, what is the factual posting of that category, all categories in that particular state. So this is the roster which explains us everything. This is the date of joining also. From here also we can come to know. From 19 number, serial number 19 to serial number 33, all candidates, nearly 15 candidates, they have joined in the year 2016. Now out of these 15, you can see that 4 candidates are OBC meritorious. 4 candidates out of 15. Then 2 are SC meritorious. So 8 candidates, 6 candidates out of 15 are meritorious. So 9 candidates are remaining. Out of 9 also, 1 is OBC. We have selected. STs are 4. SC, 2 SCs are there. So all these candidates and SCMT are 2. That means general candidates only 1 and 2. These 2 candidates are general candidates. Actual general candidates. General, we are unreserved category candidates by birth. So these are the 2 only candidates. Otherwise, all are there from reserved categories only. So this is the nature. This is the actual. I have explained you how they are. The roster is comprised of different categories. Okay.
Yeah.
Now that is. These are the wastages 6, and here these are the additions are nil. So in MOF summary, it only see this addition column. It is entirely blank. It is all 0-0s are there. That means there is no addition in this year. But wastages means reductions. They are there. 6 are there total, and they are also shown of which category it is. It is general category 2, SC1, ST2, and OBC2, like that. So these are all. This is all description about the roster and summary, which is not found in any other banks or institutes. It is only in our banks we are having this. Now here, this is the summary of backlog. What I told you, that backlog is normally shown in this summary. And this summary is famous for in our bank only. It is prepared by our bank only. No other bank or institution prepare this such type of summary. Here you can just notice that 7 candidates of ST category, that is the backlog. But if you see the MOF summary, 3 candidates already excess. Factual position is that these 3 candidates are excess in the roster, even though this backlog of ST is 7, there can be such a position. Because why it happens sometimes when the roster is contracted, reduced. When roster is reduced because of exit of general category persons, general category, which happened in the year 2000, when there was a VRS and many people, they have surrendered their voluntary resignations, VRS. Around 4,500 people retired from the Union Bank. So during that period, suppose the general people, they have retired more, then what will happen? The reserved category people will be shown more.
Yeah.
Their percentage will arrive more, grow more, show will be more compared to general category. So that will show the excess in the roster as well as in the MOF summary. But in fact, whenever in the last so many years, whenever there were recruitment process was carried out, in that recruitment process, there would have been some candidates not found while recruiting ST category candidates. So that is why seven backlog is there in the ST category. That is the reason, though there is an excess in the roster, the backlog is there. Now this backlog they have to clear in future recruitments. So is it clear what backlog I am talking about and excess shortfall? Sir, excess shortfall, there is no problem.
Yeah.
Because it is very clear from the your MOF summary as well as roster. It is very clear, isn't it?
Yeah, that is clear.
Yeah, but backlog is a different thing. Backlog, yeah. Just now I told you that our requirement was 6, but we could recruit only 4. So in that particular year, in that particular cycle of the recruitment, there is a backlog of 2 candidates.
But it shows 7.
Then now this is 7. This is 7, huh? Which is now 7 is shown here, like that. So that means backlog is different from your excess or shortfall. There may be shortfall also sometimes, but backlog can be there. Then also backlog will be there, or backlog may be higher than the shortfall.
It may so be when the roster is carried on for the next year,
yeah,
at that time this will be reflected, huh?
Yeah, yeah, yeah. But it is not reflected in the roster anywhere.
Yeah.
Backlog is never reflected anywhere. You have seen the roster also. I have shown you. Once again, I will show you. Nowhere there is a column of backlog. Nowhere. Only in our summary, which is prepared only by Union Bank of India, this backlog is shown. And one more thing. No other institutions also, they are calculating. When I asked Central Bank of India also, when I went to Central Bank of India for teaching this, when I saw their rosters, I immediately raise this question, where is your backlog? And that is not shown anywhere. And they also could not reply me. They were answerless because there is no such column prepared by them. This is the only unique feature appearing in our Union Bank's roster. So this roster is actually, this roster is never, this will never depict you or never show you any backlog. It is only a recruitment picture.
Okay.
Only recruitment of candidates, that is also direct recruitment. Suppose now there is a promotion of somebody, then he will go from this roster and he will go to promotion roster. Promotion roster is a different one and it is kept only for SCST. From clerical to officer, there is one roster. Then substaff to clerical also, there is one promotion roster. And then in officers category, there is no reservation. So there is no roster for scale 1 to 2, 2 to 3 and onwards. There is no reservation. Only 2 rosters on promotions we are maintaining. Okay. And other campus and all, somebody asked me about this recruitment of campus backlog and all. Now they are doing it in direct recruitment. They will be adjusting it, campus backlog, because there is no recruitment now. Now coming back to, this is what I have shown you regarding this housekeeper compune. I will show you one more roster pertaining to substaff.
This is also substaff,
na? Yeah, but housekeeper. We are having 2 types of rosters. Only Union Bank, we are having such type of roster. Only 2 rosters. One is for substaff, arm guard, peon, daftari and all. And one is for housekeeper, means sweepers and all. Sweepers and all other people, they will be in the housekeeper category. So whatever I have shown earlier was sweepers or housekeepers. Now I'm showing is what arm guard, substaff, peon, daftari, bill collector, cash peon, all those categories. They are, how many they are? Only 10 in entire Chhattisgarh. Only 10 are there. Now I will show you, this is the roster, 10 people, only 10 people. There are only one OBC is there. And see here, now I will talk about ex serviceman also. Now EX is written here.
Yeah.
At the point number 9, horizontally, if you see, OBC EX is written. Means what? This particular arm guard is belonging to OBC category and he is recruited under the vertical reservation of OBC, but also he is recruited under horizontal reservation of this ex serviceman. That is why EX is written. Do you get me? So this is a example of horizontal reservation. OBC EX, then ST EX is also there. That means what? He is an ex serviceman and belonging to which category? ST category. That means both the points of reservation are met with. Both the requirement of reservation have been done with or met with. This is called interlocking of reservation. Interlocking means both the reservations are locked in. One is vertical and one is horizontal. Which is horizontal? Ex-serviceman is horizontal. PWD, the PWD also horizontal. Because for ex-serviceman, we are... How many points percentage is there for ex-serviceman? In clerical category...
4%.
No, it is 14.5. In 4.5 is from PWD category and 10% from purely ex-serviceman. So that is total 14.5 for recruiting in clerical cadre. 14.5% of seats vacancies will be reserved for horizontal reservation of ex-serviceman. Okay, is it clear? No. Then for sub-staff category, that is housekeeper and arm guard and all that category. Now, whatever we are seeing, arm guard category. For that category, we are having 24.5% reservation for ex-serviceman. 24.5.
Yeah.
So this particular ex-serviceman category, they are recruited through their Jilla Sainik Board and all, District Sainik Board and all. And nowadays, the recruitment is not there. I think in the last 2-3 years, the recruitment has been stopped. We are not getting the candidates actually. There is a requirement for ex-servicemen as an arm guard in our bank. Arm guard now, they are doing separate special drive also they are doing. But how much candidates now they have done, I don't know exactly. But this is the position of ex-servicemen. This is a horizontal example of horizontal reservation. So do you understood the maximum of this horizontal and reservation? Horizontal there, reservation.
There is no UR, no?
No, UR is also there.
Mm-hmm.
In UR category also, this ex-serviceman is there. See the point number 6, Ganesh Singh. He is a general EX. That general EX means general category ex-serviceman.
Yeah, yeah.
So like that, any category there, if he is an ex-serviceman, it will be noted there in the roster. Because of that, we are able to meet with the reservation requirement of horizontal reservation of ex-serviceman. Similarly, in...
For horizontal reservation,
yeah,
whether we have any same like that roster points?
The points, no,
roster points... In the sense for SCST, OBC,
they
are adding 100 points. Like this.
Roster will be same. Roster will be same. If 100-point roster, 200-point roster, or whatever, 13-point roster, whatever the roster.
No. My question is not that. See, this horizontal reservation.
Yeah.
Now, you have to, within this 10 vacancies, now they are recruiting 10 people.
Yeah. Out of that, four people are ex-servicemen.
How they arrived at 4?
Our requirement is, whatever out of 10, what is the requirement? Say 14%, 24%. I mean, they wanted two people only.
And then they made 4.
Yeah. See, general, there is no requirement, percentage reservation. General. And This is only what I say. Talk about the strength of the roster. Strength of the roster is 10 now. But it would have been 20 earlier or maybe more than that earlier. So during those particular years, they might have been recruited. That is also there. See, in 2005 first, that is general ex-serviceman was there. Then after that, only in 2008, there is one more recruited. Then in the year 2015, we have recruited two, only this one, ex-serviceman only. So that depends on the total number of vacancies in that particular year. And horizontal reservation will not have any points in the vertical area or vertical column. See, that is why. That is why you will not, what is your question was, where is their points? Is their points are given? No? Yeah. There will not be any points because these points cannot be shown because it is not a vertical reservation. Only in vertical reservation, you will show the point, which is allotted only to SC, ST, OBC and now EWS. Now EWS has also come. So their points are, they are given in point number 10, 20 like that. Because 10% reservation, no? So 10% reservation, first person will come on the 10th point, like that. So here, but in case of PWD and ex-servicemen, there is no points earmarked for them in the roster because roster is vertical. Roster, see, anything, if you go on adding, it will be vertically you can add. Horizontally, you cannot add. That is the problem, isn't it? So that is why this is a horizontal reservation. This is the difference between vertical and horizontal. Is it clear?
Okay.
Now I will talk about PWD also. PWD, how many percentage are reserved? Earlier 3, now 4.
Yeah.
4%. The 4 categories are there. That is, you know the category. VH means version visually handicapped. Then orthopedically handicapped, and then this
blind.
Blind is a vision that earlier, first one. Then deaf and dumb, hearing impaired, that is hearing handicap. That is also third category. And fourth category, now it has come as those who are mentally ill, and those who are having all these disabilities. That is, he is blind also, he is handicapped also, he is deaf also. So these three are together with somebody, he will be coming in the fourth category. That now four percentage is reserved for them. That means out of every 100 recruited, 4 you will have to recruit from the this PWD. So what are their points? See, now they are given some points. Now this is the horizontal reservation, but then also on which point they should be, their point can be reserved. Which points are reserved for them? 4 points are reserved for them. Now it is first point, roster first point actually, then 26th point, because there will be four groups, no? One is 1 to 25, second 26 to 50, then 51 to 75, and then 76 to 100. These are the 4 groups in out of 100. Each group, there will be one physically handicapped person. So first will be the first point. In the first.
Why point. They are fixing first to point?
Actually, it is given by the government. I will reply that also. See, why they are given first point is that they should be given the first priority, that we should at least, if one person is selected, one recruitment is done. If an out of total candidates coming for that, if there is a handicapped person, we will definitely give preference to that handicapped person first. That is the reason the point one number first point is given in every recruitment. First point is given to the handicapped person. Either he may be blind or he may be orthopedically handicapped or hearing impaired. He may be anybody. Yeah? See, it is not necessary that first point should go to blind. It can go to hearing impaired also. That is deaf and dumb. It can go to orthopedically handicapped or it can go to the fourth category. So not necessary that it should be blind or thereafter like that. There is no chronological order for that. But as you said, as you asked me question, that why first, it is out of social necessity. Social, that because they are not getting jobs and they will not be getting jobs so easily. They will not be able to clear the exams also so easily. So that is why first point will be given to them. This is government guidelines as per, and it is justified. It is justified. This is a horizontal reservation. We are not. Hello. This is not, we are going by any whims or fancies of anybody, but these are government guidelines. And it is just to give some help to them or additional care, taking additional care of them, nothing else. So 4% are reserved. So every 100 people, we have to see that 4% are coming from PWD. Now, this particular PWD, there should be a 40% disability, minimum 40% disability. Then only you can take them. One more thing I will just, for your information, I will share with you that recently in 2016 also the act was passed for this people, PWD. Act was passed. There is a one commissioner for these people at based on the Delhi's capital. And there is no, what you can say, promotion. In promotion also, this PWD, they don't have any, this means they have reservation in promotion also. But ex-servicemen, they don't have. But these people, they have reservation in promotion. So now clerical to officer category, there is some, but again, there is a horizontal reservation, no vertical reservation. So next thing is that these people are posted near to their place of birth or place of residence. They should not be posted far away. Or even on promotion, they cannot be posted away from their original place of posting.
Yeah.
This is, and even though one more thing I will tell you that even suppose a person who is has become handicapped after joining the service, suppose somebody's eyes are lost, vision is lost, he will not be dismissed from the service or he will not be expelled. He will be kept in the service as long as he is alive. And he will be given all the emoluments what he was earning earlier. Suppose he was clerk or officer. So he will get that officer scale 1, 2, whatever it is there. He will get that salary by sitting in the regional office or doing some MRO, giving some information.
Will be assigned to some work.
Yeah. Some work will be assigned to them. But he will not be thrown out of the bank or service. So that is the facility given to these people. Then secondly, the persons who are having physically handicapped or PWD children, those who are having kids who are having some problems, PWD problems, all these category problems, even their transfers will not be done out of the state or out of their place. Because why? Because some handicapped children are depending upon them. The parents of those children who are handicapped, they are also not transferred out of their state. So that is also one more thing I wanted to make you clear about it. So if somebody asks you about this, even OBC candidate also, you can give this information to them that their posting is not done away from their place of posting or place of birth. Okay.
So my one person is, now you are telling about that PWD. Points number 1, 24, 25 like that. The same way for ex-servicemen, is there any point like that?
No points.
Only for PWD,
that is also out of social sympathy. Because of Article 41, we have given this reservation to horizontal reservation to PWD. Government has given, I mean.
That is what you
mean. Yeah, yeah. So that is why this points But for ex-servicemen, because of horizontal reservation, there is no such point. You cannot bifurcate such points. Only for PWD we have done this. Now, next is that I will show you about this 13-point roster. Now, for this roster, if you have any questions, you can ask me on the other last session, no doubt. Now, see, there's one more point I wanted to show you in the roster before going to 13 point. See, now this is a see, this is the seniority list. This is our seniority list of the same sub-staff who are house armed guard and all other than housekeeper. They are 17. In the seniority list, if you see, how many are there? 17. Isn't it?
17.
17 people are there. But I am showing in the roster how many? 10. I am showing in the roster only 10 people. Why this is? Because this list of 17 contains this 7, 1, 2, 3 conversion up to 7. What is the conversion means? They were earlier sweepers or housekeepers. Now they have become daftari.
Okay.
See, all these people have become daftari. Here, if you can see their designation.
Yeah.
All the 7 people, they are daftaris. Now daftari means they have come in the substaff other than housekeeper category. But they cannot be shown in the roster. Why they cannot be shown in the roster? That is why I have deleted them. And I have shown only 10 persons, last 10 persons. From that is from point number 10 to point number
11.
9 to 17. These 10 people, these earlier 7 people, because they have come on promotion. This is a promotion. Daftar is a promotion for housekeeper, isn't it?
Yeah.
It is not a cadre change, but it is in the
internal,
same cadre.
Internal
promotion. So this internal promotion is cannot be shown in the roster. Cannot be shown in the roster. For them, a different roster could be prepared, but they cannot be prepared also because it's the same cadre. See, when promotion roster is prepared, when they are crossing or transacting from one roster, one cadre to another cadre, one cadre of say substaff to clerk, that is another cadre. So there is a reservation in promotion and that roster is different. Here they are in the same cadre. They are only getting a higher position. It is called higher assignment. In our bank, it was called earlier as a higher assignment, if you remember. So, this is a higher assignment. This is not a promotion. One more thing. So, this cannot be shown because it is not a direct recruitment. And roster is maintained? Roster is maintained only for direct recruitments. Is it clear? Roster is maintained only for direct recruitments because all those people, these are appearing 10 people, they have joined directly recruited in this category, directly recruited in this substaff category. They have not been joined as a sweeper and then came to this level. So that is why all direct recruitings will be shown in the roster in the because this is the same method of recruitment, direct recruitment. In RAID, it is there. So direct recruitment will never have any higher assignment people or promoting people. Okay. That is one more point I wanted to clear. Okay. Now I will go to, I think I've almost, I have covered all the aspects of roster. What you can see, What you can see in the roster.
13 point.
Now we'll go to 13 point. Now 13 point roster is also same roster, similar roster, because there is no change in that roster type and all.
Yeah, still far. People should know how it is, it look like.
Yeah. No, it looks like, it looks like same. Whatever I'm showing, roster for cadre strength up to 13 post. Now name of the organization is different. Some educational communication. Now base, post-base recruitment roster. Now this is why there is this only 13-point roster. Why we have taken this? Because the sanction strength of this particular roster is only 10. So here only 10% rosters will be there totally. But if you see this roster, it is some replacement cycle number is there. Replacement cycle. See here, replacement cycle is there. Now it is up to 9, there is some direct recruitment is done up to 9. But these people out of these 9, 1, 2, 3, 4 people have resigned in between. So when these 4 people are resigned, this replacement takes place, because 10 they can recruit only 10 people directly. Direct recruitment total strength is 10 only. But earlier they could have recruited only 9. 10th was not available. That was a backlog, definitely. But then this replacement cycle is 1 minute. This replacement cycle is replacing the person who had joined on this particular date. So they have written this date also here. The earlier person. Means what happens in this L-shaped roster or 13-point roster, what will happen? The roster strength, suppose it is a roster strength is suppose 15 people. But sanction strength is only 10. So after 10, what to do? After 10, how to recruit these people? So after 10, the 11th point will again, depending, he will be recruited only if one person from earlier 10 is resigning or he is going out. Unless he goes out, this fellow cannot be taken. So that is why this roster is folded from that 10th point, because that from after the 10th point, 11th point cannot be recruited vertically there. They have to go horizontally in that roster. But that will be shown not horizontally, that will be shown as replacement cycle. And it will be shown as replacement of earlier person. It may be general, it may be whatever the point comes. The point will be same. Now what happened, why it was argued against the 13-point roster? Because in that 13-point roster, what was happening, that if you divide 100 by 13, how many times it comes?
Maybe
seven times. Minimum. So seven out of this particular 13 point, how many OBCs are there in 13? Only 2. Only 2 or 3 OBCs will be there.
Yeah,
3 OBCs are there in
every fourth point there will be.
So 3 into 7. How many it happens? 3 into 7? It will be 21. So you are getting six vacancies less. That was the main argument against the 13-point roster. Because resort category people, what I can say, ST people will not come into picture at all. They will not be recruited because 14th point is a ST point. See, 14th point will be ST point date. That will not come in the picture at all. And SC will be only one versus SC person will be recruited. Every 7 means that will be only 7 people will be recruited, SC also. So that was the reason why there was total opposition to this 13-point roster. Because of 13-point roster, vacancy, reserved category entitlement would have been reduced. Isn't it? So that is the main argument against the working of 13-point roster. And our bank is not doing any 13-point, keeping any, maintaining any 13-point roster. Only those universities, educational departments and all those, they used to keep, because their cadre strength is very limited. 3 or 4 of professors or like that, lecturers. So that is why they were having these small rosters, 13-point rosters. But that is that those 13-point rosters is not giving justice to reserved category. That is very clear. Now I will show you what government has shown us, how that L shape is looking. L shape looks like this. No, 1 meter, not this. See, this is the L shape. This is the actual L-shaped roster. Now, first one is for recruitment, direct recruitment. So, OBC is also there. See here, no 14 point is ST, but it is not appearing here in the first initial. One. Yeah, first initial recruit. Yeah, but it is shown here. Horizontally, it is shown. Means when I am recruiting 14 point, I will definitely recruit ST person. I will definitely recruit this ST person. So then only my cycle will complete, because all categories are coming in. But then it takes time. See, suppose this is the first year recruitment. Then this ST person may be recruited after 20 years, after 50, 30 years also. Isn't it? That is the loss. Yeah. That is the loss of ST category. That is the loss of reserved category. Whether it is ST, ST or OBC, doesn't matter. So, because of this particular L-shaped roster, we are having this opposition. We will definitely oppose this. So, this is the OBC, this is the direct recruitment roster where 3 categories are concerned. Then, here
it is. One more question.
Yeah.
People has also raised it. Yeah. That within that internal reservation promotion is there, like sub staff, for example, housekeeper to daftari.
Yeah.
So when he is promoted, we are showing the roster point against that name as daftari or housekeeper.
No, roster point, it will not come. No, he's a acha, means you want to say,
his designation will be mentioned as daftari.
Yeah, daftari. Now I have shown you, same example I have shown you. That he was earlier this 7 people, what I have shown in case of Chhattisgarh housekeeper, roster. In sub-staff category, the roster that is shown as daftari, but not in roster. It is in only seniority list. Because higher category, higher assignment will not come in the roster. Because roster is meant only for direct recruitment.
Okay.
Now, just like...
What about promotion?
Promotion, you sub-staff to clerical. That is, you can tell me. Sub-staff to clerical, in that promotion roster register, it will be shown. Those people will be shown as a clerk. They will be shown as a clerk. CTO. Now, here we are seeing, on the screen, promotions roster. So in this also 13-point roster, again only SC, ST and UR are there. So again, same thing will be there. SC is coming once, ST is coming only on the 14th point. Isn't it? So that is why this L-type, this is called L-shaped roster or 13-point roster, which should be always, we should oppose this, because it is... because it is against the reserve. Okay. So now I shall go to another. I will show you another roster. 1 minute. Direct officers. PWD roster. I want to show you how it is. It is a separate roster. PWD roster, separate roster is also prepared. This is as per the government guidelines, as per the instructions of Commissioner of PWD. See, here we all the officers recruited. This is officers PWD register. There are three categories we have to prepare. Officers PWD register, then clerical PWD roster, then sub-staff PWD roster. Means every state, every regional or nodal regional office has to prepare one more roster for PWD. Now, what are the columns? Why it is prepared like this? I will tell you. Now, here you, as I told you, this is the vertically we have shown the roster point also. Now, see this, 1990s, from 1996 we have to maintain. Because this act was passed in 1996, earlier act. So, from January 1996. So, this is the first person who is this fellow is not a physically handicapped. He is a general person. So, it is in this column here, whether the person appointed is VH, HS or OH or none. We have written none. Now, first point is rear mark for which category? VH. VH means blind. Vision handicap. So first point is, because this is the old roster, that is why first point is VH. Then now next point should have been 25th point, correct? But 25th point, we have not shown anything because this is the old roster. Earlier, how many points were there? Only 3 points. Earlier, PWD was having only 3%. So their points were 1, 34 and 67. First point is over. Now this is the second point. See here, 34 point. This is the hearing handicap, deaf and dumb. So this is the second point, earmark. We have earmarked this in the roster. This is the PWD roster. This has to be prepared by every institute. But some institute, they are not, some banks also, they are not preparing. But our bank, we are preparing all these rosters. Now, say this last, 67th, that is the third point. It is OH, 67th point. So earlier, only 3 points were there in the roster, PWD roster. And they were earmarked like this. But against all this, how many people we have recruited, that people, and how many PWD we have recruited, that you can see on this side. Hello? Whether the person is appointed as VHHS or like that. So here, see, you can see.
No, sir, I am in a Zoom meeting, sir. Excuse me, I am in a Zoom meeting. Please call me after 6.
Okay. Sir, this, if you see the last column here, whether the person is appointed is VH, HH or OH or none. Here, it is shown as none because no handicapped person has been so far recruited. Now, how much it goes, just we'll go on. It will be, see, so far nothing has been there, isn't it? Then... Nobody is there.
Excuse me, sir. Can others can mute their audio, yeah. Sir? Please. Some vehicle sounds are coming.
Yeah, yeah. Sir, see, this is the 291. That is the third cycle. 291 serial number 291. That is the third cycle. It is written 3 year and 91 here means this is the third cycle of 100 people recruitment. See here, 100 is the last number here. So 91 is the 291th candidate who is OH. OH means orthopedically handicapped. Okay. So this is the first candidate in officer category in the year 2001. It was recruited. Earlier, we could not have any candidates. So how many candidates should have been recruited by this time? 291 means nearing to 300. 300 means how many? 3% per 100 means 9 people.
Yeah.
9% should have been recruited. So how many? We have recruited only one. That means what is the backlog? Backlog eight. Is eight. So in the summary of this, we prepare a summary also for this. Only our bank is preparing. No other bank is preparing. This summary, in that summary, we show how many backlog is there. Then how many inter-exchanges also we are doing. Huh, now one more thing is there here. PWD, we can do inter-exchange. Whereas SCST, OBC, no inter-exchange of vacancies allowed.
Yeah.
Okay. But PWD, we can do it. Suppose blind people we are not getting. And one more thing also is there. Even if we get blind people, how to utilize, how to use them, how to put on them, which job we will put on them, put them on. So that is a difficult job finding. The suitable job finding is a difficult for VH people. So what we do in certain categories where VH cannot be or blind people cannot be posted or recruited. For example, Armed guard, you cannot recruit a blind armed guard, isn't it? Blind armed guard, you cannot use recruit. So what we'll do, we will orthopedically handicap or hearing impaired also, it is difficult because if he cannot hear, he cannot do anything.
Yeah.
Only he can see.
Correct.
Orthopedically handicapped, you can do somewhat, some way. You can utilize him as an arm guard. But normally we don't recruit arm guard, which is a PWD. Normally, isn't it?
Yeah.
So, but here we can exchange that vacancy. Suppose VH vacancies can be exchanged for OH vacancies or HH vacancies. HH means hearing impaired. So that exchange is done only after, say, 1 year, not in the same year. 1 year gap should be there. Then third year, we can do this exchange. And in the fourth year, because PWD vacancies are lapsed after 3 years. So we have to give them time for 3 years. After that, there is a exchange. And then in the fourth year, we can recruit by way of exchange of vacancies between these PWD vacancies. So now see here, all OH is there. All OH, maximum OH we have recruited. All OH are recruited because they can be recruited for officer's job. Now job category, job description is also important. Now sweeper category. Suppose sweeper category, you cannot recruit a blind person. That is also there, isn't it? So yeah. these are all OH is more. So I will now show you directly the summary because this roster will be a big one because now from 1996, I have taken this. Now it is only 2006. So up to 2019, the roster will be having all the people recruited officer category in all scale 1, scale 2, scale 3, like that. All categories are there. This may be only scale 1. So scale 2 also will be there. Then scale 3, like that. All categories, all cadets, there will be a PWD register. Clerical also, all states, they will be having all clerical PWD. And substaff and housekeeper. So these are the different types. Okay, now I will show you the summary. Summary of... this is the summary. Now this is of which summary of... This is the West Bengal. Sir, West Bengal. They are having 216 total substaff, housekeeper, everything included. This is included everything. Here, we don't bifurcate. Only cadre is bifurcated. Now, this is all substaff category. So, all are mixed. Housekeeper, substaff, everything is mixed. As per their date of joining. So, this is a PWD roster of West Bengal, state of West Bengal. Reservation roster for persons with disabilities, substaff, all, including all, direct recruitment of all the substaff and housekeeper, both. So they are how many? 216 people are there. So we'll see all this as earlier I have shown, see this VH category, first point is VH. Then here also, 34th point is HH. It is written here, HH. Earlier points, these are earlier points. 67th point, it is OH. So this side is what? This side is ideal roster or guidelines as per the guidelines. And this side, we have recruited, see here, three handicapped people here. And one VH, blind person also we have recruited in this year 2009 here. So this is that particular year recruitment, we have found these people and we have recruited. It is possible that we may not recruit. See, earlier we have not recruited a single person. Only one person has been recruited earlier so far out of say 166 candidates. So that is possible. Now we'll see that how many candidates are there. Total 216. This 16 means this earlier 200 and this 16. Is it clear?
Yeah.
So now we'll see the summary. Now this is the summary. Summary for the recruitment year 2014. Either state of West Bengal, Calcutta. Now here see total vacancies. Now total vacancy reserved up to previous year. 200 means earlier, what happened? Earlier, there was recruitment up to what? How many people were recruited? 197. 197. And this year, how much vacancies filled in during current year? 19. So total has become now 216. So that is what total roster number, correct? Total roster number is 216, tallies with just now roster we have seen here.
Yeah.
216.
Yeah.
Okay. So this is the total numbers recruited column. So, but earlier year, that is 2013, we were having 197. So 197 means how many total reservation? 3% on 197 will be 6 people. Isn't it? 6 people, 2 blind, 2 hearing impaired and 2 orthopedically handicapped. So total 6. So these are the what total vacancies reserved as per the record of 6, it is shown here.
Mm.
Now in this particular year, total vacancies up to the previous year, how many vacancies you have filled? 1, 4 and 1 means 1 blind person, 4 hearing impaired and orthopedically handicapped 1 means how many total 6 you have recruited. All 6 you have recruited. So there is no backlog in the last year. When you have recruited all the 6, there is no backlog. Is it clear? See, there were requirement of 6 candidates. Remember? Then how many you have recruited? You have recruited 6 candidates, 141. So there is no backlog in the last year. Now, this year, you must recruit 1 candidate, current year.
Yeah.
Because 19 candidates you have recruited, that means first point has come 201. 201 we have not recruited. Actually, it is an error here. Here we should have shown 1. 1 I should have shown here. That is an error here. So it should be 1. Then it will become 7. So total vacancies filled up to the current year should have been. But here it is. Why it is not shown here? Because it is. This year, we have not shown any, we have not recruited any candidate. Reservation for current year, here we have not shown 1 candidate. Here, here it is error. Here, I have to show 1 candidate. So, it will become 3 and total will become 7. So, that was the error is here. Here, actually, I should have shown one number. Then it will become 3. Then 3 plus 2 plus 2 is 7. But here in the vacancies field, it is 0. Out of 19 candidates, no reserved PWD candidates have been recruited. Now, the total remains the same, 6. Now, this is all exchange of vacancies and all. Inter-exchange.
Yeah.
Now, how you will ask me, now how much hearing impaired is only 2. Reservation is 2. I have recruited 4. How? I have taken exchange from these 2 categories. Two people here, they are taken as an exchange. So 2 + 2, 4. Then only I could recruit 4 people. Got it clear?
Yeah.
Because this one from one, this and one from this category I have taken. Okay, that is also shown. That is shown here. Interaction. This is vacancies interaction. Then in the last, you see, there is no backlog. So all zeros are shown. All zeros are shown. Here, backlog of reserved vacancies up to the next year. It is a total backlog issue because last year there was no backlog. But here, one backlog will come. One backlog will come. Why? Because in current year, there was one recruitment, which is not shown here, that error. Because of this error, there is no backlog shown here. But otherwise, if you had have shown here one, if I modify this one, it will appear one here, one backlog here. So that is the how this summary is prepared. But this summary is only prepared in Union Bank. No other bank, no other institution is preparing this. And this is very difficult to understand also. I think I am able to explain you. I was able to explain you, I think, to the greater extent. But unless you do it, work it on your own, you will not be able to do it completely. So I think I was able to clear this this backlog also, isn't
yeah,
it?
Yeah.
Now we'll stop here for this PWD. We have completed almost every aspect of this, but I will just show you some of the rosters of some other bank also. I will show you 1 minute. See, now this is the
roster. It will be same.
Yeah. But not our bank, other bank.
No, it will be same only.
That roster is different. That is why I'm showing you.
Why?
No, not difference. Difference in the sense what we are showing some two columns here on the left-hand side. That is government guidelines. This is not appearing in this Andhra Bank roster. See, the here serial number are there. Only serial number is there. Means their share of entitlement in the roster, that is not shown here. Only that is what I wanted to tell you. Other than this, this is the actually government guidelines.
Wow.
This particular format is given by the government.
Mm.
1 minute. So, this particular format is given by the government. Actually, we should have also prepared in the same format. But if we prepare in this format, you will not be able to understand what is the backlog, what is the excess and all. See here, at the end, they have not given any summary also. They should have given summary.
Yeah.
But summary is not given. This is Andhra Banks, I'm showing.
Correct.
So now it is merged with us. So they have to now mold their working also. Now that process is, I think, going on in the central office. That is what I heard. I don't know exactly what they are doing.
Okay.
Actually, it is a big work. Big work.
Okay.
Huge work is there.
Okay.
Because all three banks merging together and all.
That I think with this, I think we can go for some questions and answers.
Now we can do.
Because only half an hour is there.
Yeah, half an hour is there. That is why I'm stopping here. I think I have completed more.
Touch the various areas. But doubts will be there.
Yeah.
Our people may have some doubts also.
Yeah. Please. No.
So,
is there anything in the chat? I don't know.
I will tell you.
Yeah. Please, you tell me.
So that you can
reply. Yeah.
One person is asking how sanction to strength is decided in each category.
Sanction
to strength.
Yeah, that is the board of directors in case of officers and clerical in our bank. Board of, it means every category, that is even sub category also. A board notice put up and board, in the board they approve. Sanction strength is approved on depending upon the number of retirements during the year. Because how much we will be losing the staff and then new openings of branches and all. Depending upon those requirements, that each per branch, how many people are minimum people requirement? Say three people are required or four people are required. So in that way, they calculate the requirement. That note is put up by our, you know, Mr. Rao. He was earlier in that particular manpower department. And he used to prepare the note, and that note was put up to MD or board of directors. And then board of directors will sanction that how much recruitment we should do.
Okay.
In that particular, suppose
it will be decided by the board based on the retirement, resignation, and future business. Okay. Right.
Yeah.
Next question: when sub-staff, you are having two rosters in Union Bank.
Yeah.
One for housekeeper, another for armed guard.
And sub-staff, armed guard and others.
Why? But the pattern is same. Why it is different? Two rosters. Both the percentage is same. Local recruitment only, but why that we should maintain two rosters?
I think there are salary structure. They have different
because of that.
Yeah, yeah.
But housekeeper is lower than this cadre.
Yes, yes, definitely.
But overall, sub-staff cadre, they are in the place in a lower position.
Yeah, it is the lower
in terms of salary.
Yeah.
In terms of salary and qualification, recruitment itself is different, I think.
No, recruitment is also different in the case, because sub-staff category also direct recruitment is both the same only. Not
education qualification same. Huh?
I think education qualification, there is a
difference. Huh?
Yeah.
Okay.
Armed guard and all. See,
armed guard I can understand.
Yeah.
But other sub-staff versus a housekeeper.
Yeah.
It's also different. Huh?
I think only difference is not in recruiting. I think difference is only in salary structure, nothing else. Because Daftari, cash fune, and the bill collector, they are getting special allowances. Special allowances. So that is why their category is made different. And this housekeeper, sweeper only, they are not getting any allowance. They are not getting any allowance. That is why I think there's, because of salary structure, they are separate. Yeah, next.
Next one, one person has asked about how we are deciding this physically handicapped percentage. I told that 40%, is it okay? Disability.
40% minimum. Minimum.
40% and above.
Yeah, 40% and above.
I replied, I think it is okay. Na?
Yeah.
Okay. Then, this... which is wrong? I don't know.
Sir, actually, the reservation for SCST, scheduled caste, and OBC is defined. But so far, deaf, dumb, mute, and ex-serviceman, no certain percentage is defined. So this how reservation or certain quota is defined in the roster.
That is as per the government guidelines, only that particular percentage are defined, not as per population. I think your question was regarding the population, means as per population, OBC percentage is decided, or as per the SCST population.
Suppose 27% and 22.5%, total 49.5% is defined. Another EWS 10% is defined. Total is 59.5%.
Yeah.
Okay. Na. So this is reserved category. But within this 59.5, within this, deaf, dumb, mute, ex-serviceman. So na ex-serviceman. So people are being observed. People are being taken up.
Yeah.
Within 59.5%. No separate reservation is given. So, what is the quantum? What ratio of this 59.5% is given to these people, deaf, dumb, mute, and ex-serviceman? So, I want to know this actually.
No.
I think this is also a calculation.
Yeah. But there is no such defined areas or defined percent or quantum. It is given anywhere in the government guidelines. It is total, on total 3% or 4%, for example, for a PWD, and only 14.5% for in the clerical category, and only 24.5% in sub-staff category for ex-servicemen. That is given as per the government guideline. There is no, it is on the total vacancies, sir, not in these particular sanctioned categories. In these particular sanctioned categories, there is no percentage reserved. There is no percentage reserved. They are sir, purely vertical category. And these people, when a SC person, he is also ex-serviceman. So he is sharing that point because of horizontal ex-servicemanness. But he is recruited in the bank because of both these two, because he is both. He is SC also, and he is ex-serviceman also. Plus, he is occupying in the roster the vertical point only. Horizontal point is, sir, horizontal point is only, it is horizontally obtained. It is not a part of, say, out of 100, we can give 1 to SC, 1 to ST, 1 to OBC, not like that PWD is given or ex-serviceman is given. It is only on the basis of total vacancy, because that means you can say they are recruited as per vacancy-based rosters, not post-based rosters.
There is no category-wise reservation.
It is on the whole. It is on the whole.
Yeah. Totally, it should be 4%.
That is why.
Either it can be you are alone, or SC alone, or OBC alone, or total, all combined also.
All
that. It can be anywhere.
Yeah, yeah. And that is why I use the word vacancy-based roster is applied for them, because they are recruited on the 3% or 4% of the total vacancies, which are recruited.
It can be any category.
Yeah. There is no, as for Dr. Amrit Ashu has asked.
Okay.
Yeah.
Next.
Is it okay? Clear.
Yeah, yeah. It should be okay.
Yeah. Thank you.
Then anybody?
Any more questions?
Sir.
Yeah.
Sir, this reserved category people.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yes.
Please.
Reserved category people comes under meritorious. Meritorious means that vacancy will be reserved, no?
No. You are not understood. Meritorious means he will occupy general seat.
He will occupy
general seat. He will suppose in particular process, out of 100, 27 seats are reserved for OBC. Correct? Now, out of total result, what total result we got? We got total 27 candidates of OBC. They have passed this exam. Moreover, three more candidates, that means total 30 candidates they have passed. And these three candidates have taken higher form, means with a higher rank. That is a meritorious rank.
Cut-off mark.
Above the cut-off, above the merit cut-off, there are three people there. So these three people will not be included in that 27 quota. Yeah. So this will be an addition and will be shown under the category general or unreserved. It will not be included in the sanction strength or sanction entitlement. Yeah.
Sir, Karunanidhi, sir.
Hello.
Yeah, yeah.
Hello.
Yeah.
Sir, one confusion. One thing I want to know, Lavangri sir, also.
Yeah.
Sir, the earlier there was a set guidelines that those OBC who have applied under the OBC category, but not taken any privilege of the reservation, like age relaxation or marks cutoff, marks relaxation, no relaxation has been taken. So, and he is the meritorious candidate. So he has been taken under the OBC MT, OBC meritorious.
Yeah, meritorious, correct.
Okay. But recently any guidelines came that those who applied under the OBC category will only be taken up under the OBC segment, even though they are meritorious like that. This is there in the guidelines recently.
No, nothing like that.
No. Nothing like that has come so far.
Okay, OBC MT is still continuing.
Yes.
OBC MT is still continuing.
Still OBC MT, yes. Very sure.
Okay, those who are meritorious and not...
Those who are having the cutoff mark of UR.
Yeah, yeah. They are more than cutoff mark of...
Moreover, I don't want to use that word meritorious. All are meritorious. Yeah. Only thing, the cutoff mark of UR category, if you are coming under that, you will be in that segment. If you are in that cutoff mark of OBC, within that, you will be in the OBC segment. That's all. Only the cutoff mark defines the category wise.
Say, for example, cutoff mark.
Yes, correct. It's the right word.
Yeah, 68 marks. Suppose 68. The persons who are earning more than 68 marks out of 100, 69, 70 and above, they all will become meritorious. That is the cutoff mark for you are. Cutoff mark for you are.
But the condition is this, that they have not taken any privilege of age relaxation or other things.
Yeah. That is there.
That is all there.
Whatever your doubt was there, that was regarding the state of Gujarat. State of Gujarat has made that. They have made, but they have reversed their judgment. That court has given, High Court of Gujarat has given that Ahmedabad High Court. They have given this judgment that there should not be this meritorious, we should not be there or like that. But then they reversed there. And also one more thing, that if the person is applying through that reserved category, he cannot claim general vacancy also. But that is not the case now, because general category, he can, even though he is OBC, he can compete in the general category race also. He can come in the meritorious sector also. So that was in Gujarat state, but that is reverse. Yeah, that was
Another question.
Yeah.
The DOPT has devised the roster format.
Yeah.
But our bank has inserted two columns, whether it is valid, one person is asking.
Yeah, it is valid because it has nothing. We are not violating government guidelines.
Yeah. You are giving additional information.
We are giving additional information, which is very much better than other government format. It is superior to government format.
Okay.
Right. Definitely.
There was no objection. Nah?
Yeah. No objection. Yeah, I have appeared before the ministry also earlier. Mm. So for this, they appreciated that whatever we have given is good. Even they appreciated. I remember Mr. J.S. Fogart was there, under secretary. He appreciated that we have this column. No other banks are using these columns. Actually, it is good.
After amalgamation.
Yeah.
Hello.
Yeah.
Andhra Bank backlog and Corporation Bank backlog will be taken into consideration or not?
Yeah, maybe. Because after merger, it will be one unit, no?
Yes. Corporation Bank.
Yeah, that backlog means they have to recruit under the new identity. That backlog can be carried forward and can be utilized.
That should be.
Can be filled up. Yeah.
Hello.
Yes.
Sir, myself Sangram Holambe. Just I have posted a few questions also. And longer, sir, tumcha WhatsApp vor par me share kelet. Just for my understanding. Yes, sir. Also to Jankaruna di, sir.
Yeah.
Sir, jo SBI mein abhi jo apprenticeship shuru hone wala hai. That is already in market. On that, some light. And the questions which I have asked is are for my personal understanding.
You are from?
My name is Sangram Holambe, sir. I am from Union Bank of India.
No, no, which branch?
In central office, sir. I am looking for MLP protection. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Yeah, already posted my five questions, sir.
You have posted. I think I got one answer. How sanction strength is decided?
So my view on that, whatever the answer sir has given us, just my personally I'm sharing that basis, what we are right now doing is a postmortem analysis. After having a sanction strength, we are doing whether they are taken correctly or not. But my view is, the sanction strength itself has a problem. In a particular branch, how much people should be there? Because right now, the people who are working in the branch are facing that problem. Whatever we are discussing is postmortem analysis, I would say simply. That required strength itself is not getting sanctioned in a correct way. So how to go ahead about it? That is my concern. Because
that is not a roster session. You are taking a policy decision.
My concern was that whether we have some kind of, I can say role to place in this particular presentation.
In every meeting, our association is placing the requirements, and we are telling that the bank has not recruited any such staff, even though requirement is much. And as far as the armed guard is concerned, we are the only association that has taken up at the central office for which some recruitments have happened. So, but the bank is having certain limitations. They say we are discussing with the government how to proceed for sub staff when there is no interview. Like that, they were just delaying. And the problem continues, but beyond the meeting, we don't know how to proceed further.
Okay, that was only my question. I was thinking on all these points, nothing formal.
We are very much a citizen of this matter in all our meetings at central office, and beyond that, our letters also, we are insisting that each branch should have a minimum 1% as a sub staff.
Yes, sir.
And also for armed guards, we have taken a position that each branch should have it. But the bank says we are not in a position, we have given outsourcing, which we have objected to that. And we have said that government guideline says that 24.5% should be reserved for the exercise fund. We have asked for that data also. So all these things, we are putting the bank in a corner. But they have got certain excuses and they are delaying it. But in the next meeting also, we will give pressure on that.
Okay, sir. No issue, sir. Just I want to understand that. Nothing else, sir.
Which department you are working?
Sir, actually, I was in RMD. I am actually basically looking after MFTP section, but that as I organize a restructuring, that section itself has got transferred from RMD to finance and accounts. So from last month, I am in
finance. GM now?
CFO, sir. Samal, sir, is now GM. The department has a function has shifted, but in that also there are different issues, sir. So now this is not a correct forum to discuss this. One thing that I want to say that in general over that bank is not doing their own, actually the core areas. We are a welfare association, but the role we can directly point out that they are not doing their basic things. Let's say whenever we get opportunity, I will put that points also. I'm right now don't want to know. Yes, sir. Okay.
Anybody else? So that I will ask our now 4:45.
Okay, sir. It was a very fine session, sir.
So anything else? Anybody?
I think we should conclude, sir.
One second. We should not leave anything because this is an occasion.
Sir, you have any questions? Any questions?
Regarding this roster points, we are also seeing that in central office. I am not convinced about this 2/7/1997 of the stand taken by this bank for that it should be from 8/9/93. So I am working on that. Trying to address that matter with the finance ministry. I already told Rao also, well, in the last meeting also, we have told him that we are not convinced. They don't have any guideline. See, insisted is there should be any guideline for any action, whether it is right or wrong. Guideline should be there on based on which a public sector bank has to work. That is what I wanted, but there is no such a guideline. I said that it is not correct. But somehow, because of this 1 year, now this year, we are not able to meet the central office officials. And we are not able to follow up the matter also. Anyhow, it is on our cards. And I am now, since NCBC is also, we are trying to bring them also to that notice. This is not pertaining to Union Bank alone. It may be all the banks also.
Yes, sir. Yes,
so
sir.
It may be a general issue also.
It is a general issue, sir.
Yeah. So we are taking up that issue with the finance ministry. And, let us see anything is happening so that the benefit will come to the OBC SCST.
Okay.
OBC will have more benefits now. And also, that is what our intention. So anyway, we will try that. That is the only area where we are having a different view on that. Other than that, okay. Your explanation today is okay. And most of the people will have some idea about that. Lot of questions may come. That should come.
And
whatever questions, let them also send it to us so that we will escalate to you. You please give your reply so that we will have that. If necessary, we will have one hour session on question and answers also.
Yeah, definitely.
Because everything cannot be addressed in a single 4 hour session or 3 hour session.
But
it will have some idea. We will have some idea.
Yes.
Many of our people have not seen the roster also.
Because
all did not have the opportunity. Only our primary office bearers, whenever they go to central office or regional office, they see this kind of roster. Normally, ordinary member doesn't have an occasion. Even though in the workshop we are giving our office bearers rotation, every year we are giving a chance. But all are not covered. Ordinary member never can come to that workshop. Because every year means it will take long years. It is an occasion today. It is some eye opener, I can say.
Totally.
So now let me with this. I think one second. I will say one chat. I will see that.
So,
somebody is asking your number. You can, if you feel, you can give it to them.
No problem. You can give my number. Should I tell them number this?
Shall I put it in the chat box?
No problem. They can contact me.
So that if any doubt is there, they'll let them also have a discussion with you.
Even afterwards also, if you have anything, you can discuss me. Only thing is that you tell them that they can call me on WhatsApp call. Because my call may not be. So WhatsApp call can be.
WhatsApp call only. I sent the message chat to everyone. It is only WhatsApp call. You can be contacted. Raju, you are on the line. Mr. Raju.
Recording.
Hello. I think you can go ahead with your vote of thanks. And go ahead, please.
Dear friends, it was a nice and useful occasion for all of us, because we could interact with each other in a pleasant manner. And also, in
one second, Raju. Labankara, you can close your screen. Share screen.
Share screen.
So that we can see the people also.
Also,
an eye-opening program on ROSA system for many of us. Our sincere thanks to Mr. Vikram Lingare for sparing his time with his, and also for presentation with his rich literal and practical knowledge on this subject. Explained it in simple and lucid way. It's commendable that he started his lecture explaining the history of social justice in a brief way. We must remember that social revolutionaries like Pule, Periyar, etc. struggled a lot to build a unity of Bahujans, that is non-Brahmins, in order to achieve their legitimate right. But now it's standing that some political parties create divisions among the Bahujans, that is among non-Brahmins, instigating rivalry among them, as if same some caste alone dominating and others are ignored the name of reservation. So in this regard, I request all our friends to be alert and educate our youngsters the importance of the unity of Bahujans through social media, social functions, and wherever possible, wherever you get a chance. Before I conclude, I express our sincere thanks to our leader, Thiruji Karunanidhi, for organizing this webinar and identifying the expert on the subject, like Mr. Vikram Lingare. Our sincere thanks to Lingare once again and all participants on this webinar. Thank you all.
Thank you, Raju. I think in addition, I have to thank our working president of Federation, J. Parsardi. Our Vembayan from CPCL and Mr. Muthukumaran from Madras Fertilizers Limited and other friends from Federation, other affiliated associations, and all our friends from various states, including our office bearers of Tamil Nadu. I think with this, we'll be happy to meet all of you in our next session, possibly by December. We plan to have one session, important session. We are trying to fix the dignitary. Once it is finalized, we will let you know that. With this, I once again, on behalf of the Social Justice Academy and the Empower Trust, thank Mr. Lavangare and all the participants for joining the session and make it a lively one. Thank you. Thank you, Lavangare. Thank you all.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you very much, all of you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
Thank you. And Amrudanshu, thank you. Amrudanshu.
Yeah.
Yes.
Yes, sir. Sekaran, sir.
Amrudanshu,
you have to thank you.
Thank you, Sekaran. Sekaran, sir.
Just at the end, he says,
now
sure.
Lavangare is the authority for us. As far as the roaster is concerned, you are the authority for us. For us. You have the confidence, telling for us. Wish you all the best, boss.
He's a scholar.
Yes. All the depressed, oppressed class should join together and fight together. The day is not far away. We'll join and we'll fight it. Yes. We have got a stand.
Thank you, Ranjit ji, Vinod Prashad ji, Simbal ji.
Thank you, sir.
Very nice interaction.
Arun from Kanpur.
Any informal discussion? Informal.
No problem.
It is exchanging pleasantries. No more pressure on that subject. So no more teacher and students. Now all are students.
Correct.
Lifetime students.
Correct.
Yes. Very nice. So India is together.
Really, we all are very thankful to Tamil Nadu Unity Empower.
Yes, whether he is from a Prime Minister constituency or a South Kanyakumari to Varanasi. Yes. Okay. Nice. Thank you.
Aur Ravinder sir, kaise? Ravinder sir.
Ravinder Rao.
Bahut badhiya hai. Kal humne bahut sara function kiya Mahatma Phule ke wo unki smriti ke liye. पूरे बिहार में अनेक जगहों पर हम जो जी सब नेशन में है वहां से बढ़िया से हम लोगों ने मनाया किया करुणानिधि की याद हर जगह बताई मैंने करुणानिधि जो भी कुछ कर रहे हैं उनका जो अचीवमेंट्स है ओबीसी के लिए उन सबको हाईलाइट किया हमने और आज वो लावंगले साहब ने जो भी कुछ किया वो तो हम जानते हैं कि अथॉरिटी है वो उनके जैसा नॉलेज पूरे देश में किसी के पास नहीं है जहां तक रोस्टर की जो बात है बिल्कुल वो हमारे जेब है हमारे क्लास के तो वो मैं उनके सामने बोलना थोड़ा अच्छा भी नहीं लग रहा है लेकिन फिर भी वो जो मेरे विचार है मैं जरूर प्रकट करूंगा उनको बहुत धन्यवाद आप इसी तरह से वो हमारा गाइडेंस देते रहें जब कभी जरूरत पड़े तो हमें गाइड करते रहें और करुणानिधि जी के लिए बात तो हम कुछ भी नहीं कर सकते वो जो भी कुछ कर रहे हैं हमारे लिए ओबीसी के लिए पूरे देश के लिए वो बिल्कुल अनपैरलल है कोई भी वैसा नहीं कर पा रहा है और हम तो यहाँ पे हर दिन ही उनका जो अचीवमेंट है ओबीसी का जो